No.
Even he realized what he said in the song.
He don't say that part no more.
Know what he said?
I just read it.
What is it?
He can't repeat that.
Oh, yeah. But then you heard what he said after that, right?
Hell yeah, nah.
But a brother ain't gay.
It's your birthday.
Hey. He even realized what he said. He even realized
it, bro.
Hey, man, stop. Get up out of the seat. That was creativity, man.
Like, he didn't even realize what he said.
He was like, damn.
Oh, look. But it was gay.
It's your birthday.
Hey, yo, Kilo ass. Hey, bro.
That's why that nigga the goat, bro. That's why he the goat. He did that shit. And nigga was just skating. He didn't even give a fuck. That was our favorite part.
Putting on the word, man.
It's your birthday. Baby.
I'm fucking these niggas like pussy, but a brother ain't gay. It's your birthday.
He tried to change the subject.
He took it too far, man.
It's your birthday. It's your birthday. It's your birthday.
All that, nigga.
That nigga, that's stupid, man.
He took it a little too far.
A lot of lines ain't gonna stand the test of time.
Oh man,
I was saying that shit on the show, then they got mad. I can't stop doing it.
Biggie got some shit.
Don't even repeat. Yeah.
Biggie got
don't get them New York niggas started, please.
Well, he said it. Shit.
I know.
You can't take back what you said.
Crazy though.
Wow.
I think New York is still mad at me for fucking up them lyrics.
Oh, that shit. Oh.
Nigga.
Damn.
Hey, yo, man. That's all.
I wasn't gonna bring that shit.
Yo, what the fuck? Yo.
But what happened, bro?
You got New York niggas be, yo.
I think this is your first time ever really just speaking your piece. They still want to know. I'm waiting for this one, son.
Yo, son, is a nigga here with Tim's on right now.
Yo, you gotta apologize to the whole New York, man.
I need an answer.
Nah,
yo, he going to some answers. He need to address this shit.
Nah, New York, listen, man, y'all know I apologize first and foremost. I didn't grow up on the Biggie. You grew up on Biggie.
I'm gonna be 100, I did.
So, you know, Lil' Kim at me, I ain't wanna tell Lil' Kim, no.
Facts.
Right.
But I know I didn't know. But they were supposed to put him on a teleprompter, though.
What
it give you?
How you say they said I'm sorry to Mike?
They're supposed to put it on the...
He said I couldn't tell him
though.
They had it when we had it in the rehearsal.
But when they
I still wouldn't go get it, but I want to see it though.
But it's different, like, you gotta think in the studio, I don't even write, so did a relive that shit.
You go to practice, Juan.
I had it in the room, but it's different just to study lyrics. Like,
oh yeah, cause it's not yours.
Yeah, like, right. I don't know the beat, the tempo.
Right.
This ain't like a, I don't want to say it was no banger. Like New York, right. They probably banger.
It was a banger, but you ain't going to practice somebody else's
some
song
legendary
that you
shit.
didn't listen to.
Yeah, like, you know, I ain't good with that shit.
You should have just told the kid, look, I love you, but I can't do that.
I couldn't do that.
But then,
guess what's so crazy about
what?
It?
I went and got the cool just sweater.
That nigga dressed the fuck up. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and
get the Coochie down to the
side.
I'm back there practicing, but you know sometimes you get on that stage, that shit different.
It's way different. Fuck that. The show must go on.
The show gotta go on. You gotta at least do it one time. Just what? To show I fuck with y'all.
Well, everybody was mad at you,
man.
They didn't even say your whole name after you fucked it up. They were like, and that was Quan.
I know that was bad. Like, I watched the band. I saw, like, Fat Joe Fat. They tried to slow everybody face down. This is bad. Them lyrics ain't pop up, man. That might slow them sticking with it.
Fat.
For real, man.
They ain't do you. They did you wrong.
I can't read it, man.
Oh. Damn.
That was crazy.
Either way, you know.
That nigga said I couldn't tell Lil' Kim no. This the fuck you could.
You was about to
die. That's hard.
Nah, but if he would have said no, then the day would be, oh.
You know? He don't fuck with you. Then you go catch from another angle. He said, fuck Biggie.
No, he didn't. He just said no.
He just said no.
Like, but then, like, I can't tell Lil' Kim, though. It's like, this Lil' Kim, this goddamn. Yeah. I got to do this shit. This Lil' Kim. What? She probably asked you out that corner. You gonna do the route? You like, I got to. What the fuck?
Listen. I got on that stage, though.
It came out, like, the first couple words came out, and then it was just like, I seen it, I was like, oh,
that wasn't even right, because I watched it back with the caption on. They got, like, the dot, dot, dot. I was just like, yeah, I slipped. But it's all good, man. You know what I'm saying? Accountability is everything.
You live it, you learn, no? Yeah. No. And like you said, that wasn't something you grew, yeah. Like, a lot of shit is what
I'm,
you,
I'm going there and do a show, sell out and redeem myself. I'm going to do my favorite biggest song.
Facts.
Yeah.
Facts. All them dangerous. Ain't too many. Let me do that one. That can hang with us. Straight up, we know. Angel does.
Yeah. Like, you just made everybody in New York feel good. Yeah. Like,
come on, if you like, we had our own.
Alright, son.
You know something.
Yo, son, he's alright.
He good. He good.
Send that nigga some pizza.
He good.
You should have did that one then. You should have just did that one.
The player went on out. Oh, yeah, LaCan had
that one. That one, baby. It was too.
This would be the perfect time to say it, though.
What? Hey, man, welcome back to the 85 South.
This is the number one show in American households where black people pay all the bills. Yeah. Yeah. Where black people pay all the bills.
Oh, that's me.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's us.
Hell yeah. Number one show amongst people who don't know they father like that. We don't bother with that. Cause we coming right back each and every show. We gotta go a little bit deeper. We gon' smoke a bunch of blunts so we can get some good sleeper. Yeah. My nigga, you do it big, we do it bigger. So how the fuck did you figure that we weren't them niggas? I'm looking at some property. I might just pull the trigger. Yeah. It's a big old house, but the one next door is bigger. It ain't owned by niggas. Yeah. So it's super cool. Yeah. Long as I got the biggest one that niggas got is cool too. Shit, I'm looking at some more shit. I might just buy a helicopter and ride around on some low shit. Cause don't take me too high, because I'm high right now. So why the fuck I gotta lie?
Yeah.
I got my nigga doing ad libs. We stacking money so we can add cribs.
Yeah.
And not the kind where the babies sleep. Big ass house, me and my girl walk around naked, G.
Yeah.
Now this just shit that I done thought about.
Okay.
I put it in a rap, but I ain't never talked it out.
Okay.
Sometimes I really get beside myself. I bought the house next door to me, so I live beside myself.
Whoa. Turn that shit low.
All my rap's super real.
Okay.
Ask anybody, hey, that's where Los live.
Yeah.
But that's his other crib.
Yeah.
We don't know where the fuck he is.
Yeah.
I told you they gonna do it big, but I still do it big.
Yeah.
Cause I'm the nig. Yeah. I mean, I'm the nig. Me and my niggas riding around rich homie Quan. We them niggas. And we make these bitches feel some type of way.
Okay.
I hit on Tuesday and Friday.
Okay.
Cause I done got old, I'm taking days off. But we be working, taking no days off. I hope it pays off.
Yeah.
Yeah, hey, talk your shit. You can look around the room and see that we got a very special guest in the house with us today.
Man.
This nigga right here, man. One of the coldest entertainers.
Hey, man.
You know, of our generation. One of them cold young niggas, bro. This nigga be moving around, you know what I'm saying? Hitting these harmonies and raps and shit. Like, you know, he could be James Brown grandson or, you know, like, you know what I'm saying? Could be related to Boosie Collins and them and shit like
Come on,
he throw a little funk in there. Then a nigga might sing a note. And then a nigga might throw some gunplay in there.
Come on.
Then a nigga might pull a bitch or something and talk some rich nigga shit. You know, feeling like the man when I walk through.
Come on.
Some type of way make you feel some type of way.
Come on.
Man, we done spoke the nigga name up on the show for about 4 years in a row. And now, if you don't believe me, real 85% is already know. We been trying to line this up. It's well overdue. Niggas don't get no sleep no more. Yeah, man. We go way back, man.
Come on, man.
This nigga promised his uncle he would never, ever stop going in.
Come on, man.
And I ain't.
Come on. And still ain't stopped.
And I ain't.
Nigga walked in the club, $50,000. We don't know where it came from. We don't know if they paid him to come or he just had $50,000 and pulled up at the club. He didn't give us all the information, but he gave us enough to have fun. Walked in, $50,000. Where this money come from?
I always thought they paid him.
I thought he had a show before he went. This is an after party. He had to be.
He came with $50, then they paid him another $50. Nigga left out with $100.
Why? Ain't shit outside you can buy it at that time of night with no goddamn $100,000. Leave some of that money at the goddamn house. But anyway,
you gotta get the back.
You had to get it to the house.
You right. You right. You right. You all the way right. That's your goddamn money.
Yeah.
Now everybody in this room got a bunch of broke homies. But a lot of niggas ain't got a bunch of rich homies, ladies and gentlemen. Rich homie Quan.
Yeah.
In the trap.
Yeah. Okay.
Talking good shit with the gang, man. Welcome to the trap. Hell, you been up to?
Shit, man, I've been chilling, man. You know.
Yeah. The 2022 version, man.
Yeah. Ain't not been chilling, man. In the studio. Breaking back. Working. Taking care of them kids. You know. In that studio every day, you know, cooking up. I ain't gotta be in the kitchen, yeah. But I'm cooking up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Still putting on for the seats.
You got to. Don't ever stop doing that.
Come on, man. I'm out of Atlanta.
Shout out some of your favorite places in Atlanta. Places that you feel like don't get enough shout outs.
Man. Traffic on Thursdays.
Come on.
Oh, that's off of that Gauche's, our Cascade breakfast.
Yeah.
Okay. This ain't even for no, what, man? Bussing. Yeah, yeah, man. Gauche's right there by the house, man. Who else, man? Papa Doe. Oh, yeah, I fuck with that Papa Doe extra hard. Yeah. Like, that's like 3 times a week.
Papa Doe?
What? That catfish and dirty writing.
No, but you a fool.
Oh, man. Go up there, man. Tell him I sent you.
All right, man.
You know what I'm saying?
I would love to do that. Hey, Rich, who's the Quan sent me? Who?
The one in Marietta.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I used to work over at the Papacito's.
Oh, for sure.
Back in the day.
Yeah,
so, man. He used to eat that Papa. We swap food at Papa Doe's.
Seafood.
They do.
New Orleans style. Yeah.
Yeah, it's fine.
I get them in P.L. Chang, Mr.
No, they're Chinese.
I know.
And Papa Doe better.
Yeah, Papa Doe.
He better quality.
Yeah, Papa Doe, yeah. Papa Doe sit down and eat. Yeah. You know, but you can sit down at P.L. Chang too, but
it's not. I ate at Papa Doe's, I just don't remember.
Papa Doe's it.
I gotta eat at Papa Doe's again.
Well, I'm so mad. Are we still boycotting Houston's or what? Because I want
a wine.
I want one right now.
It was just
now.
That one. I've been in Houston. It was just that one. We had to shut that
one. We back in there?
Yeah, we shut that one down.
Listen, bro.
All right, so we back in there.
Yeah, we just got to go to
I got to go get me one. Shit, why y'all didn't tell me, man?
I've been waiting. We can go to another one.
When they had everybody boycott, I was still sneaking up
there. Oh, that's why the shit didn't work.
Bro, that motherfucker's so good.
That motherfucker's
good.
The wine ribeye? What? Yeah. That be buzz? Like, I always get the filet. I'm tripping.
You tripping.
You tripping out, bro.
That's what's keeping
the Hawaiian ribeye got the bone in it.
Bro, that's what's keeping the doors open.
That what? The Hawaiian ribeye?
You tripping. That's the best shit they sell.
And that spinach deal be
the Hawaiian ribeye, it taste the same? Yeah, I always get the filet.
Nah,
I be tripping
that little
piece of meat.
That
yeah, you getting out. Nah,
then he getting the shit well done. He
that baby look like an Oreo cookie. What the hell is that?
I know they told me I don't get it well done. You get told well done, huh?
Well, I get mine well done, bro. Okay. I don't want to see no blood. I tell the nigga when you cook it and you think you're done, cook it 5 more minutes. No cap.
That's how I like mine too, man.
What, well done?
Well done?
Yeah.
August 7th. Y'all been waiting. Y'all been saying when we coming to L.A. The Magic Johnson and them used to play at.
Lake Show.
The Lake Show.
They don't play that no more, but they used to.
It ain't the Lake Show. It's the 85 South Show, though.
You dig what I'm saying?
Motherfucker describing to me some shit. The Impossible Burger or the some shit. He no, like, he yeah, man, listen. Impossible. It ain't me. But it look like me, it taste like me, it feel like me. That said, nigga, it sound like you describing the deal, though. I don't want none of that.
Hey, August 7th.
Your ticket's still up. Good. You bought them the first time.
Yeah, yeah. Nigga, we can swap it out. That's how we do it.
You know what I mean?
You already know what it is.
Uh-huh.
August 7th.
Pulling up.
Uh-huh. Englewood, California.
You know what time it is, homie.
What's up, y'all? It's your girl, XP.
And it's your girl, Dre and Nicole.
And we are bringing the For Rich or For Poor tour to the Windy City. We're going to be in Chi-Town August 12th at the Vic Theater.
Yeah, y'all already putting up. Them tickets been going so quick.
Bruh, Chicago is outside.
They been buying them tickets up. So y'all need to make sure y'all get y'all tickets right now. Y'all got to go to poorminds.com and get your tickets ASAP.
Yes, ASAP. And y'all know, I love Chicago. Like, so y'all know we finna turn up. We gonna have some special guests for y'all. I know y'all been seeing the clips and it's going up. So get y'all tickets and we'll see y'all soon, August 12th.
If your tender's still well done, that wasn't how to cook. You're not really supposed to eat your steak with blood in it, no way.
Man, I'm not eating.
It should make your stomach hurt.
No, I'm not doing it.
It should be chewy.
The only thing that should be wrong is my pussy. I ain't doing nothing else with no blood.
Man, that should be too chewy.
Yeah, that shit.
I done had one like what it called, medium rare.
Yeah.
I don't try that shit. That shit be too chewy.
They said the blood give it the taste. No, it don't taste like blood.
I like
that. They said go down, but it digests faster.
It tastes like blood.
Damn. That's
it
not
taste blood. No, that, in the mouth.
That's the red shit.
Yeah, the mouth.
Niggas ain't blood. Supposed to be.
It's not even blood.
Nigga, I want the shit medium, and I want it still cooking when it come off whatever they was cooking it on. By the
you
time it get to me.
You still want to be on your steak as they bring it to
nah,
you.
Nah, but your steak's supposed to sit about 10 minutes anyway to cook all the way through.
So you technically want your shit
done. Nah, I be cooking that shit. I be cooking.
Yeah. You just say
yo,
medium.
What, but and just keep it hot so when it come out that sizzle.
No, yeah, that's how it's supposed to come
well
out.
Done. He just say medium to sound exquisite. No, nigga.
No, I want it medium, but I want it to still goddamn cook when it come out to me. If it's got just a little bit of pig in the center, that
but
shit
but man told me, he said, when you be asked for and well done, he said, sometimes they can give you the oldest steak and you want to know because you're getting it well done.
Well, put that's seasoning cold, on that bitch.
I don't know what you're cooking anyway.
You might not get the best steak.
I don't know what you're cooking anyway.
For sure.
Keep I'm glad
I don't want to see no pink.
Man,
that ain't supposed to be in your plate, bro.
What?
That pink? That blood?
No blood. I'm not. I'm
even
not,
if it's
I'm
no,
not
even if it's
no
in the steak,
ain't
even
no
like
liquid.
A
you shouldn't be seeing red. You can
ain't no
see.
Liquid. No, you see pink. Mm-hmm. You see pink like
that
in the
that means it ain't done. My mama always said, if you see that, that means it ain't done. Now you get worms. The old folks will scare you into some shit. You can take that shit with you for the rest of your life. Bro, you'll get worms. You'll be in the middle of the room. You'll get worms eating this.
Man, you told me what last year you was going
get your shit medium
well. Yeah, I'm going to eat outside.
Medium well.
I'm going to try it, man.
Medium well.
Can you still see the pink though?
Nah.
No.
Medium well.
Yeah.
That's kind of like tender.
That's
the perfect temperature to
no,
get that muffin.
Medium well is when you bite it, that's when the blood come out.
No, it's not. See, that's medium. That's medium.
Yeah, that's medium rare.
That's medium rare. That you're talking about. That's see, it's rare. Levels to this shit.
Okay.
Rare is just where they just brown
the
outside.
Right.
That's how the
that's
white
bloody,
people eat that shit.
That's bloody.
And then medium rare.
That look like flesh.
That's right. Medium rare. That's when like, you know, that's where the chefs like they shit at. But then it's like medium.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then you got medium it's medium well. Well. And then it's well done. Well done is where the motherfuckers be like, this motherfucker don't know how to eat a steak anyway.
Man. I don't give a fuck. I'm paying you to cook my shit. You don't want to be no chef. Take your bitch
but
out.
Everybody can't make steak, though.
Put that shit back on the grill.
Everybody can't make steak. No, what I, and I don't know.
Well, I learned how to make one, boy. Them shits, I can whoop anybody at a restaurant.
YouTube will teach you a lot.
That YouTube shit?
YouTube will teach you a lot. Go to YouTube,
you know. All you need, get you the T-bone, one with the bone in it, salt the bone, salt both sides of that bitch.
Okay.
Put it in the refrigerator for an hour.
Cook
come back, pat that before? Bitch dry. You ain't gotta be a day before, just
so
an hour.
Just an hour marinate.
Yeah, an hour, let it marinate. And
Clayton English steak
pat
recipe.
Pat that bitch dry, right? And then put whatever seasons you wanna put on that bitch.
So you just put the salt in there before?
No, you can put that on it right before you put it on.
Put on the grill.
Yeah.
Right.
You ain't really gotta do that putting it on the grill, but if you want to, just so it's a little more.
Ain't gonna keep the
yeah, that's how you gonna get the good little sear.
Olive oil. You gotta put a little.
But you pick whatever your season is. Throw that bitch on there. That bitch only really need to be on that bitch. Since y'all motherfuckers only need to be on that bitch like 3-4 minutes, maybe, east side. Like,
I fucked around trying to cook some steak last week. Fucked around, forgot them bitches. Them bitches sitting out. I'm like, it's some steak in my house. It's the meat. Man, I done had the steak for 2 days.
Burn it up.
I done forgot.
Oh, you tripping.
Tripping. Went to JJ.
Damn, I just had a great bitch. I just
went
had
JJ
a great
fit,
idea.
Forgot I had steak.
I'm going to get into real estate.
JJ got crack and make shit rent. Up. What's it that, so?
I'm going to get into real estate and rent places to people who can't cook and just take the kitchen out.
What for?
Your whole apartment building, none of these bitches got no kitchen.
How the hell they gonna eat?
They eat out all the time.
We gonna take that whole room out. You can eat. It'll be somewhere you can. Ain't gonna be no kitchen though. Ain't no fuck, no stove, nothing.
You gotta cook something.
You need a refrigerator.
Hot dog.
That's the worst shit, being in a hotel with no refrigerator, nigga.
Oh, this how I'm gonna fuck them up. We just gonna put all that shit in the lobby, nigga. You gotta come downstairs to use the microwave, nigga.
That shit's so lame, bro. You gotta walk with your plate. That shit hot in here.
Man, you down there late as fuck.
Man, I'm looking
at you. What you doing here? Trying to eat.
Damn, bro. I'm like, you can't bring it to the room?
Right. You know, right.
Let her.
Even though high end hotels don't be having no motherfucking.
Now, this is going to be the next play. They going to just link.
We need a deposit.
They going to have an apartment building that's owned by Uber Eats, and they just going to bring you food every goddamn day. Watch.
That's hard.
Watch.
Hey, $150.
That's my money that I made.
TGI Friday.
That's my money that I made. You know what I'm saying?
Think about it. You're going to be watching National Geographic. They're going to have a story about some motherfuckers who love McDonald's so much that they're going to build a fucking apartment complex with the McDonald's down there. And part of you paying your rent, they just bring you your shit every day. You just hit the button. And they just charge it to your rent. What?
That's too much free. That's too much free shit.
No, you finna die.
You paying for it.
Like Burger King.
They gonna put it in your rent. They gonna put it in your mortgage. You gonna pay for it in your mortgage.
Exactly.
Burger King got 40 nuggets for $2. How the hell?
They got what?
40 nuggets for $2. How they do that? What that is? Y'all got 40 nuggets for $2. Don't fall in the hell out of nuggets. Yeah, let me get 120.
Put
nigga
buying
that
chicken that
coming
from.
But I don't know what that is,
bro.
Nigga buying
that shit.
Bro,
I know the game.
I
used to work at Burger King. You been saying this before.
I've been peep game.
What they
bro.
Do, bro? Bro,
sometimes they be fucking up and they be thinking shit gonna be bigger than it actually is, right? So you know, like, if you gotta
you
go back. You gotta go back to before the nuggets was 2 for $40.
Right.
You gotta come back. The motherfuckers probably came out and they was $1.99 for about 4 of them, and the people went online and went crazy. So they had ordered all these nuggets, but then people stopped buying them motherfuckers. So now they got extra nuggets. Now they trying to get rid of these motherfuckers. Cause look, they got Jurassic Park coming out. And they trying to sell all these regular nuggets before they get all these dinosaur nuggets, because they don't want to have 2 cans of nuggets at one time.
Look here.
Nigga, I remember one time we were selling dinosaur star-shaped nuggets for about 8 months. Jurassic Park came out and didn't do shit.
They were fucked up.
Because you could, these particular ones, like, you usually could cook a basket of nuggets and it'd be straight, right? These motherfuckers were shaped so funny, you had to just cook them individually and, like, shake them, or they would fuck
really
up.
Got $40 for two.
Nigga.
Yeah, $40. They be promoting
this
shit.
They do it so often.
No, 40 nugget for $2.
Are you hungry? You can get 40.
I'm gonna tell you what make Burger. I'm gonna tell you what make Burger King the most money.
Bring your broke ass on down here.
People laugh and say they don't eat.
You finally got something for all you
broke motherfuckers. People laugh and say they don't eat at Burger King.
Stop asking us for deals and coupons.
I got dinosaur nuggets.
Eat these motherfucking nuggets.
That's really how they are. The shit that make them the most money is when they sell them water. Two for one.
You come in with your
man. Hey, man.
Hell yeah.
This shit bring your bro, man.
That nigga said, but you stupid, bro.
Bring them badass kids, too.
Got 40 nuggets. for $2. But all the accessories, all the other shit, like biscuit, that shit like $3.99. Print toe, like $8. You like, oh, y'all regular pricing on that shit. But the 40 nuggets?
Don't nobody fuck with Burger King till them fucking Whoppers is 2-for-1.
Whoppers,
niggas be coming in there.
I don't know what happened. Can we fuck with you? We just giving y'all what's been given to us. We just telling y'all what we see when we buy this shit. About 40 niggas
wrong.
Just to see what it was gonna do.
This, I'm gonna give you.
I'm gonna
say some
I
shit.
I'm still
that only people at Burger King gonna be able to relate to. Burger King got the best food in the world if you can eat it within the first 30 seconds of it being cooked. If you can't eat that shit immediately, don't even worry about
so you need to eat
it. If you don't believe what I'm saying, try this out. Next time you go to Burger King, tell them that you will wait and cook your shit fresh. That's the best Burger King you'll ever have in your life. Like, nah, don't give me shit. Run to me right now. I used to work here. You gotta act like you worked there. Nah, I worked here. I used to work at Burger King High School. Tell them to run to me right now. And when they cooking your shit, if you know what a hamburger shoot is, if you look right there, you can watch your shit drop.
Right.
Yeah, hey, give me meat.
Get it!
Yeah, give me shit. My shit coming down, that's mine. No, he put mine in there.
Right.
And tell them to put it on this side where you can look. If you look straight through the french fries, you can see the grill. Every Burger King set up this way. If you look through the french fries, you can see the grill. Then you gotta stand there at the counter and watch your shit fall. Trust me.
I can't do it. Why you work at Burger King? Oh, you used to work at Burger King.
Boy, I'm telling you. You gotta eat that shit within the first 5 minutes.
You gotta be eating, so basically you gotta be behind the counter.
No, basically.
Yeah. But you know what? I fuck with Checkers. They lines to be too long. They give you your shit when they get ready.
I like that Wendy's.
What? Checkers, man, you want some fries?
Not no more. Checkers. I like Wendy's in 1998. That was when Wendy's was at their best. In 1998, Wendy's had some of the best hamburgers in the world. I don't know what year Dave Thomas died, but I tell you about Wendy's in 1998. Wendy's in 1998 had this burger called the Double Stack. That bitch was 99 cents. You know what a double stack, a real original double stack cost you at Wendy's right now? $4.
Hold on, wait a minute.
Let me tell him. Nigga, the double stack,
tell him.
I bullshit you not. The motherfucker was this big, and it was 99 cents.
For real.
Nigga, well, hold on.
They had a whole 99 cent menu.
You could get a double stack, you get a junior bacon cheeseburger, that was $1. Nuggets was $1.
Man, a large fry.
But I ain't gonna lie, them burgers started to get real, like, drink. Small.
Bro, them motherfuckers started getting big.
A crystal burger, but a regular bun.
That's when Dave died. Soon as Dave Thomas died, quality went way down. Wendy's was one of the only motherfuckers out here that had real ground beef where if you bite it, some other fall off. Am I bullshitting? Ask anybody who was around in 1998. Wendy's burgers used to come out and have.
Everybody
should have been around. The only burger place that you could bite in your burger and that motherfucker still had grease in it.
Facts. They had a real chocolate, they had a real frosty. And frosty?
What? And that machine ain't never broke.
Never. Nah. You can get you a frosty.
I don't care how gangster you is, but you gonna lick on that frosty.
Nigga.
Yeah.
You ain't got no spoon, you gonna
That's how niggas learn how to eat frosty.
You gonna lick that frosty.
Eating frosty?
You like, what you got? I ain't got no frosty.
Nah.
I fell off hard.
They did. But you gotta think, what you gonna do on the road? So what's your role? What's your go-to on the road? What's your go-to on the road? What's your go-to on the road?
Go-to food?
Yeah.
Which one?
No, not food. I mean, like fast.
It used to be White Castle.
Man, that shit, ooh, tap my stomach.
I'll take shit for White Castle. I know that. I'd be like, listen, let me get 4 number shits.
What that shit is like in the mid, boy. It's like in the mid. Yeah.
That's
what
I know.
It's not in the midway.
I don't care.
You know what I kind of like that they ain't got down here? What? Sheets and like Wawa, where they just make you a sandwich.
Oh, that Wawa is trying to gross stuff. Yeah, Wawa, that's like on the Philly.
Cause you can go to that bitch 2 a.m, that bitch open, they'll make a sandwich or some shit.
It depends on what.
That Wawa hot. But you know what? I'm gonna tell you what niggas sleep on. Fuck that, I'm gonna talk. I thought this shit out.
crispy, crunchy chicken.
Bro, it went by my house. Yeah, listen, that listen.
Shit. Boom.
Man, I'm biscuit.
Woo.
That shit, that bro. Biscuit good, huh?
Y'all niggas is sleep.
Bro, my girl said, like, why you ordering that off? She said, you ordering that off the Uber? You gonna get that? Baby,
crispy, crunchy bro. Chicken.
And you gotta get extra biscuit.
That honey bro. Biscuit, that bitch for $2.99.
Niggas don't you gotta get doing them first come back. Hey, you gotta get doing them motherfuckers for they first come back.
I don't even care. You gonna eat half of the sandwich trying to get the biscuit and stay over there.
They got extra butter on that motherfucker.
Bro, and the butter way it's sitting there, bro. The only thing they gotta do is they gotta take it out that goddamn basket and put it in the plate.
They gotta take it out.
Put it in the plate. Yeah. No, you gotta put it in one of the American Deli plate. You can't have it in that little nacho basket.
But it's
that's
throwing
the niggas out.
Put them up.
I know, but you gotta put it in American Deli. They just throwing a bunch.
I ain't bitch one of them.
Popeyes ain't the same. They really can take over Popeyes. These biscuits alone.
Crispy.
You know what I'm saying? The chicken just to go. It's butter biscuit, man.
Listen, just stop pumping your chicken to the wedge. Yeah, the wedge is cool. They just gotta stop pumping this shit up a little bit.
The wedge is big as hell.
Yeah, but the wedge.
They eat that shit like a water.
Wedge like my turkey leg.
That's a wedge?
Hey, man, wedge like a turkey leg.
Not a bite, but like a pillow. What the fuck is this?
Nah, they gotta get out the gas station, though, man. If they wanna be taken serious in the chicken
business. They saving so much money by being in that gas station.
Nah, I'm telling you, bro.
Yeah, they are, dog.
Over here.
Over here. Nothing.
Like a side kiosk. I got the little side kiosk.
No, like.
The little side kiosk.
You know what they're saying to me? They're saying that they're scared to be a real restaurant. They're scared to be a real restaurant.
Nah, I seen the crispy crunchy
chicken. They're not a restaurant. It's a go place.
Nah.
You got to pull up, get it, because it's hot and ready right now. You can't let this shit sit.
You got to eat
it.
That's why people be hungry and don't need to really
eat.
Like, they just see it. Like, you know what? I just get it.
You let them fool you?
Is it crispy crunchy chicken?
You let them fool you?
They don't got enough confidence to be a real restaurant.
No. You let them fool you with the other shit. The
they
pizza place.
They got red shirt. What?
They got shirt.
But they got some red
pizza
shirt
place. With the little chicken thing.
There's a nigga on there with the little chicken right
there. That nigga didn't know the Hunts Brothers pizza was the gas station pizza.
I didn't. I'm ordering the shit on Uber Eats.
And he was
you
eating
still
the
fucking with
shit.
The gas station, bro.
But he didn't know.
Hunts Brothers are black and white.
This how they fucked me up, because on the app, they sell whole pieces. At the gas station, they only sell slices. So I'm not thinking that I'm ordering a delivery
You can't pick and choose what restaurant you want to get at the gas station, you getting pizza out of the gas station, just like we getting crispy crunchy chicken.
I'm going to tell you the best pizza right now, though, going out, though.
What?
Fast food, like, real quick.
Fast food.
Marco. Fucking their ass up.
Pizza?
Man, Marco fucking everything.
It used to be China Junior for me, but every time I eat that shit,
bro, Marco,
China Junior?
The way I be buying this shit, man, Marco fuck with your wife.
Oh, no, you said pizza. You talking about Chinese food.
Yeah, I'm talking about Chinese food.
You
said Marco.
Marco cool, too. I had some Marco, the skin coming out.
You got the wrong one.
Like, the skin be peeling out before me. I'm like, damn, bitch. Skin just sliding off. I'm like,
you never had no pizza in Italy? You gotta eat that bitch with a fork.
I had a croissant in London. That's
how
they had.
They're the same.
You supposed to eat that shit in Paris. Ain't that not what I had a croissant in London?
That's how they had. I was like, what kind of bread y'all got? I was like, damn, this shit.
Well, London ain't got no good food. No way from what I heard.
They do what I heard. It got better.
You can't eat no pizza with your hands. That motherfucker like.
Yeah, this shit way better.
Nah,
the last time I was over there, this shit was better.
It really made.
You around black people?
Chicken was amazing.
Oh, okay.
You around black people?
You can't hold it up.
Yeah. Bigger than New York pizza?
Yeah, I know that. Yeah,
it ain't that. It just, they really make them real olive oil and shit. So it's,
so it flinched.
That's
why you can't do it.
Hold on, we went to Italy and had some pizza?
Yeah,
come on, man.
That's fact.
Hey, man, that motherfucker so flat and that motherfucker
like
that motherfucker. And that ball. So you can't hold, you got, like, you do, what they do, they fold it. Down there, make it fold it, double, just stuff it in one take.
So they don't put all that thick crust and shit on there.
Nah.
No,
it was good, though. It was good.
Listen. It's the source. When I came back, I ain't eat pizza for 2 years.
Damn.
You feel me? I was so fucked up.
Cause that shit was good as hell.
Bro, the Uber, they bring it on the bike. Whole thing, like, boy.
Shit, I like Italy? To hear. I like hear nigga international.
But you gotta think that what they known for.
That's what I'm saying. You gotta go to the culture to taste that shit.
Yeah.
We over here eating the fake ass Italy shit. This ain't what it is. We gotta go to Italy to eat the real shit.
Drive down now, you see them nigga hanging pigs down in the.
Ooh.
That wasn't a piece of spider.
I would punch the pig.
What the fuck?
You know, I got my radio.
Yeah, it's time to go do some more traveling, man.
You know you go back to
that shit be fun. Yeah.
Sometimes it do.
He said sometimes?
Sometimes it do, man. But that just, I just got to the point where it don't matter when the fuck, like at some point, it don't matter where the fuck I go, I be ready to go back home.
For sure.
Yeah. That boy he a travel. He like me, but his
tits
has been even shorter than mine, bro. I thought mine was short.
Yeah, after
he
I
like,
do,
once I see it a couple
I'm
hours,
I'm done doing
go.
What I'm supposed to do. My mind just go straight back to the crib, like, fuck everything. We got the money. Let's go. Let's get the fuck out of here.
Bro, I'm just like that.
Man, I see y'all sleep up.
Bro, because it's like, I don't know, man. Sometimes I just be feeling like I be, we got to, and not we got to leave, we got to escape.
We
got
to escape.
We got the money. Let's go. No, fuck that. Let's not even spend the night in this town tonight. Man, let's drive for an hour. Get the fuck out of here.
Hey,
fuck this
like
shit.
Every time.
Hell nah,
we done came to Aspen. We finna
the only way I'm going, only way we spend the night, man, we don't flew anymore, motherfucker. We ain't going back to the next morning.
Man.
But you guys, but we then turn around, we could be driving 6 hours. Well, we're gonna get our ass back on that road.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you. How you know you don't like the city, nigga. When you, the earlier you get to the airport, that's how you know.
Mm-hmm.
Motherfucker be bored than a motherfucker.
Oh, yeah,
you just in the, I'm talking about you in the bed, you laying down like, I'm finna leave. Fuck this. It ain't, it's 1:30, man. My flight leaving 6. Fuck this. I'm out of this bitch.
Oh, nah. If I don't like this city,
out of this bitch at 3.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you talking about another city? Nah, deal with it. That due time, but I don't call my agent to book me something to leave early in the morning. Don't even play with her like that.
Yeah.
Don't even let me stay to listen. We do a show that night, and most of the time we flying. I'm on the first thing smoking back to Atlanta, man.
I'm leaving early in the morning.
If we got a layover, I go home for a couple hours, man. Come back to the airport, man. Don't even play with me like that. Listen, ain't we leaving from Atlanta? I'm getting to the airport. We leave at 2. I'm getting to the airport at 1:00, man.
Thanks.
I'm getting to the airport at 1:00. I don't like nobody who gets to that motherfucker too early if you in your hometown.
I don't get that motherfucker 3 hours early, man. Sitting out eating and stuff, man. I hate that. You just sitting there at the airport for four hours. But you know what? They do got a little party at the end or the Concourse. That shit a player to be there for like an extra hour and a half. At the lounge. Yeah, yeah. Well, shit, the restaurant only in the airport. I ain't say the skyline. I ain't talking about dancing line. I said, oh, other shit. Like, you shopping, chilling, kicking, all the men. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't saw that part, man. They building.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it ain't done.
You wasn't even supposed to be back there. I walked back there. I'm like, I'm in the wrong stuff. God damn.
What y'all doing over
there? Hey, man, y'all gonna. I done took 5 pieces with all the contract back there. God damn.
I ain't gonna lie, though. I love the airport in Atlanta, though.
They say we got the biggest orange thing.
Nah, y'all
done been
busy,
to a lot
busy.
Of. They said we got the biggest, and
let's
I done
count.
Been to a lot
let's
of
count.
Airport.
Let's count.
And I'm like, this shit is huge.
That motherfucker in Amsterdam. Got something to do. Smoking section.
Oh, yeah.
Got something to do.
What?
Yeah, they got no smoking section in Atlanta, too.
Not no more. You can't smoke in no more. You can't smoke in no more airports in the USA, but
thank you.
It's over
that
with.
That shit getting on my nerves.
Oh, damn, that shit ain't in the airport no more.
Nah, it's over with. But they got like wallpaper over there, motherfucker.
That shit fucked me up, man. Nigga taking them pens, joining them motherfuckers. You wild. Look at this, though. This crazy. You can't smoke at the airport,
but the dogs just shit in there where the people used to smoke at.
Yeah, they got them in the litter room.
Then they put the
dog shitting room.
Yeah.
Hey, if your dog can't shit in front of people,
you can go back. I try to take my dog and that nigga.
Is your dog shy?
Shit right in the airport.
Your dog is shy shit.
How many times you flew with your dog?
Put him behind the curtain.
I flew a couple times. That shit started getting on my
nerve. What?
I flew with a dog back one time.
I flew with a cane corso.
I hate all you motherfuckers that fly with dogs.
Motherfuckers that fly with pets.
Just know that everybody on the plane don't fucking like you.
No.
Just know that you the most hated.
No.
We don't want to even be on the plane with people. What the fuck make you think we want to be on here with your dog?
Don't wonder why people looking at you crazy.
Hell no.
I'm like, yeah, yeah.
You know what you did.
I had to buy a whole seat for the pit bull, bro.
No, sir.
They made me buy a whole seat, first class seat.
She was getting mad saying he ain't no carry-on. I was like, where you gonna put him on the plane? This shit hot as hell up under there, man.
I'm one of them people who believe dogs shouldn't be able to go every goddamn well.
It gotta be a service dog, bro.
Fuck that. I don't believe that.
I don't believe that.
We in Memphis. We do a show in Memphis.
Man, this nigga hate.
Nigga done brought the litter to the show. No, I got these motherfuckers.
Right. He brought the puppies.
He brought the water to the show.
What he had, Frenchies?
Like, no, nah, then he had the booty on there that just came out. You know, booty.
You bought what?
Why you know it? And I got to buy a ticket for this motherfucker.
Facts. That's the one you had to buy for another ticket?
Yeah, I had to buy a first class ticket.
Nigga gave me my cane corso, man.
Heavy walking through the airport, man.
Had to, my boy.
No, that's people crazy. Bigger than mine.
I bought my cane corso from Mississippi. Had to fly him.
Oh, well, Mississippi, they breed them dogs. Well, shout out Mississippi.
Yeah, most definitely.
They breed them dogs.
They have hardworking people out there in Mississippi. You live with hardworking people, they ride through Mississippi.
That's why you can't pull up on nobody in Mississippi.
How you doing? I'm from Mississippi.
Hey, man, what the fuck? Hey, you think you gonna talk about Mississippi like I ain't sitting
here? I'm happy for y'all. Like, y'all are hard workers.
Nah, that's some bullshit.
Y'all some hard workers. You be like, where you from? From Mississippi. You got work on it? Like, goddamn.
Nah, bullshit.
Y'all nigga act like Mexicans in this motherfucker.
No, the fuck we don't.
Y'all are some hard workers. Bro.
You gonna tell me that?
No.
I'm not accepting that. There's more to us than that.
What it is.
What it is. Nigga, we out here.
I know y'all like them cars, man. I'm old school.
Nigga, we like all that shit. Nigga, like Mississippi, like big shit. The bigger, the better, man.
Y'all barbecue?
Hell yeah. I think niggas in Mississippi invented that shit. It's too Mississippi to not be Mississippi. What other kind of niggas gonna be cooking outside, nigga? Niggas in Mississippi started that shit. You can go back first day of slavery, nigga. Niggas was out there. I'm telling you. They like, who over there cooking? Them boys from Mississippi. Rufus, what's that meat you cooking? Sir, well, that pig you told me to throw it away. I laid some, herbs and spices on his back. I put him on there this morning on a slow heat. What slow heat? Oh, sir, that's when you cook it all day. You be wanting us to work till it get dark, so I figures by the time
we get done
working, he be done cooking. You must be some kind of genius or something. No, sir, I just ain't no damn fool. Don't you cook nothing else, sir. I'm going to tell you now, if you hit me, I'm going to hit your ass back. What do you mean by that? If you put your hands on me, I'm going to put my hands on you. And my hands is bigger than your hands.
Yeah.
And I'm going to use my foot, too.
Yeah.
Who taught you to talk like that, my mammy?
Yeah.
When'd she tell you? When she was over there fucking your pappy. Niggas from Mississippi always been the niggas to get in trouble, bro. If you could put me anywhere in the world, I could look and find a nigga from Mississippi in 10 minutes. I don't even know why niggas from Mississippi niggas tell me they from Mississippi. I can look at you and tell, nigga, I see the pain in your ass.
Those
were
slave ass nigga, boy.
Nah, it ain't even that. It's just that you gotta keep in mind. Y'all are
slavery rooted.
Check this out. The way we grew up, you talk about your parents being old. Nigga, imagine being around all old folks. All the folks is old.
Even the young people.
So it's like, nigga, the shit that they warning us about done already happened.
Right. They giving an old clue.
Bro, this advice don't even work no more.
Niggas
ain't supposed to be eating over there with them white folks. We been did that.
Man.
We already eating together.
You keep going down there.
They say
you ain't supposed to be going down there. Listen, we can walk past them folks.
I guess you think they ice cold.
They give you unsolicited advice all day long. You can't fuck around. Like, say for instance, you start fucking with somebody, right? You know, when you first start fucking with somebody, they be like, oh, hell, you in love, man.
Right.
That girl must have put some sugar on your dick. Like, what? What the fuck does that even mean? And why you say it? Why you wait to say that?
Oh, she said
right.
Man, y'all on the phone and all that to move. She must put some sugar on your dick. That's all you walk around here talking about.
That's what you telling them? Nah, this is good. Look at you like you crazy.
Why I can't be in love?
Exactly.
Sugar on the dick.
Bro, crazy.
This is Mississippi ass shit, man.
I think I done had some sugar before.
Man.
If that's what you call it. That's why my sugar pressure is so high.
What them niggas be saying when they be getting ready to fight?
Get ready to fight? Oh, niggas don't really say too much, bro. It ain't really too much shit.
What's that shit you told me the nigga said?
Which one?
Some shit that nigga told the nigga, he said, nigga, they can't.
That nigga said, that nigga said, nigga, they can't melt you down and pull you on me, nigga.
They can't melt you down and pull you on me.
That nigga said, nigga, they couldn't melt you down and pull you on me.
Damn.
Bro, the coldest shit I ever heard.
God damn, that's
but
crazy.
The coldest shit I ever heard a nigga say before a fight, this is a true story. That nigga, this is a true story. The nigga said, nigga, I jump down your throat and come out your ass like poison if you try me, nigga.
That nigga dead serious.
What?
I'm gonna come down your throat and come out your ass, yeah?
Hey. Like poison.
Yeah, like poison.
That nigga said, hey, I jump down your throat and come out your ass like poison. This the type of shit you hear all day, bruh. Bro, I got this uncle, bro. This motherfucker, anytime somebody asks him for something, he say the most random shit, bro. Like, uncle, let me hold some shit. If I do, a Jeep will jump out my ass and run a boat over. What?
Why everything got to go out somebody's ass?
I don't know.
Hey, man. Bro, this... Whatever going on, it's coming out your ass.
Hey, hey. Hey, man, that'll be the day I march out my own asshole.
They got what?
Oh, no, but I'm going to get some money out my ass. I'm going to tell you. What the fuck are you talking about?
They got the craziest sayings, bro. I remember I used to work with these motherfuckers, these old white dudes, bro, when we was laying bricks. I was like, hell, we gotta catch up today. It rained yesterday. Well, we gonna be pretty busy. Gonna be elbows and assholes today, buddy. What the fuck does that mean? I'm gonna quit.
That don't sound right.
Man.
Sound like it greased up.
Elbows to elbows.
Shit from the back.
Okay, I don't know what that is.
Nigga, hit from the back.
Nah, I'm gonna get fat.
White man came to work one day, he walked in, he said, woo, it's hot out there. Hotter than two rats fucking in a wool sock.
White people funny hell,
man. White people at work, I used to work with these old redneck ass white men, bro. It was this one dude, they used to call him Smoke Break. Cause that's all he wanted to do was take a smoke break. Smoke break!
Great.
He couldn't wait to smoke. So look, this motherfucker said, hell, is it payday? God damn it. And take this money home and give it to mama. He said, why you gotta give it to mama? Cause she got way more pussy than I got dick.
She got way more pussy than I got dick.
Bro, this is the type of shit that I just used to sit around and just listen to all fucking day, man. I had some fun. I done worked with some funny ass people, bro.
I encounter they be racist on
the low. Bruh, that's the thing about it. Most of the white people that you be around who be racist at first is because they really ain't never even seen no niggas for real. You think cause we done seen a lot of white people that white people done seen, they some white people ain't never really seen no nigga like
close.
Like for real, like for longer than a minute or two. So when they around us, they be like, you're a person. You motherfuckers pretty much normal.
That's why they be acting. I don't know why they be acting like that.
Bro, I'm telling you, anytime you be around.
They believed all like, that bullshit they set up like, and put in place.
Why be on the plane? Other than that, I know some cool ass white people.
I know some cool ones too, but I know deep down inside, I know they call me a nigga in the head.
On
that
plane, check this out. Shit different. This is the way
you
this shit
plane,
works.
You gonna see that shit.
Hell yeah.
On that plane.
But the white people that like niggas are the same ones who don't like the motherfuckers who don't like us. If that even makes sense. Cause it's like, it's a separate kind of white folk. Like them separate. Like even white people don't like them.
Right.
Them like the Walmart, like dollar store version of white people.
Right.
They don't fuck with them. Like think of white people as like the Apple store.
Mm-hmm.
So they look at the racist motherfuckers as like, gas station, they be like, these motherfuckers ain't even real white folks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They ain't pure.
Exactly. And then this the crazy part. Them motherfuckers who hate niggas is actually broker than us.
Facts. They ain't got nothing.
Now, they're so poor that they actually believe that they're going to get some of the white people money, but they poor. They ain't. They don't fuck with them.
They don't even care about them.
Them the white people that stink when it rains.
Smell like spam. Smell like spam.
Nah, but the Apple Store motherfuckers, they got their goddamn discriminatory policies,
right,
too.
Yep. They have
and that
to.
Racism takes shape.
But that's kind of like
way, life, and they benefit from the
that's their
bullshit.
Insurance, though.
Right.
They got to do that.
Huh?
Because they gotta like make sure that they stay like clear that they're white people, because if they fall too far in the middle, they ain't going to be able to benefit off being white.
Mm.
You feel me? Like, they need to benefit, like, they only going to benefit as a group separately, so they got to stay separate.
Mm.
Because they're like, we're the Apple Store white people. Y'all want us to represent for the community. Y'all got to prop us up. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, we like Sunday clothes type white people. Like, y'all got to make sure we look good so y'all can make, hey, we about to take over the world. Remember now, hey. They keep the other white people distracted so they can, like,
pop their shit.
Exactly. That's
see,
how they.
But nigga be sleep on them other folk too now. They ain't right.
But see, that's a whole nother
A-Rab
thing.
The slave train was crazy. That was before the Atlantic slave trade.
There's still something going on.
No, they don't.
Something going on
that ain't got shit to do with us. That's why niggas is sleep
some
on that. We don't give a fuck about what happened to your people. You ain't even listening to what happened to ours.
Right.
I'm not about to sit here and look up some more shit.
No, the A-Rab slave trade got something to do with that.
I don't give a fuck about that.
They do.
It don't.
They trade nothing.
No, it don't.
They
here we go with this shit. It ain't no us. It ain't like all black people came through the same shit. Here we go with this shit, man. Because they be trying to sit here and just keep repeating some shit that somebody told
you. Get ice on.
Nigga, you gotta look around.
Explain it to me.
The A-Rab slave trade. It was way before the Atlanta slave trade.
The what? Atlantic or Atlanta?
The Atlantic slave trade. You know, they came and got us from across the Atlantic.
No, they didn't. They came and got some motherfuckers. They didn't get all of us, y'all. Don't be believing that shit. If you think every nigga came over here on the boat, you got like fucked up. Read some more shit.
It's some more, I mean, niggas was over here too.
Niggas was here the whole time. Like, look at them white folk bringing them other niggas over here. They was standing
right there.
Who were they? The niggas that
the same way
up.
That you can get in a cab in New York and the nigga tell you, oh yeah, I'm from Cameroon. That's them. The same shit. It's been the same motherfucking way the whole time.
You gotta know the path so you can know where you're going. You just can't make money and be like, oh,
that's what I'm
good.
Telling you. They
money
didn't have,
don't mean like
all right, put it this way. They didn't have to put niggas
good.
Nowhere yeah. on no piece of land ever.
What you say?
Niggas and already was on every piece of land. If you're gonna believe that niggas was first, you think they just stood in a fucking circle? That means they was first everywhere in the world.
Sure.
That's what I'm saying. So
facts.
How the fuck can you go get some motherfuckers and bring them to where they already are?
You call trade.
The motherfuckers who say they discovered
it's
America tell you. As soon as they got off the boat, some niggas were like, who the fuck is y'all?
You got the A-Rabs and you got
so
the Egyptians.
So nobody got brought over here?
All these different kind of niggas that they ran into the first day. It was some tall niggas. Then it was some little bitty motherfuckers. They ran up in the trees. And then they had some other motherfuckers who had some boats bigger than theirs when they pulled up.
Portuguese.
It was already right there.
What's so
Portuguese people?
Spain.
They what?
They enslaved the people that was already here.
Well, I thought the Indian were here.
The Indian were.
I'm asking.
Nigga.
Because if you enslave the people, that's okay.
I know why you think they give them their reparations and tell them to be quiet. Why the fuck you think they killed all them Indians?
Because them Indians wasn't going for that slavery shit. They fought back. They already had their shit together. They pulled up and was like, y'all slaves. You like, you a fucking lie.
Okay.
I got a brother, this nigga named Roaring Eagle. If you touch me, he on y'all motherfucking ass. And then you touch me.
And we from here. And we on the land.
And they touched me. Guess what?
And we know all
the Indians got on their ass to the point where they was like, hey, send some more motherfuckers over here because these Indians is on our ass.
Okay, so who was enslaved?
The Indian had the guns the first time, they had to go get all that shit.
Yeah, they had guns. They shot some motherfuckers, but guess what? Eventually, they ran out of bullets.
Okay.
And guess what? When they ran out of bullets,
the
they was like, oh, we
free?
Give up for a little bit. Teach us how y'all did this shit. Then when they taught them how to do this shit, the dirty motherfuckers crossed them and killed them with their own shit.
Facts.
Yeah, that's facts. But who was the niggas working for free?
Who was the niggas working for free?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The niggas that they stole.
Facts.
They stole them niggas.
Well, where they came from?
The niggas that they pointed them guns at, and they shot some motherfucking niggas.
No,
shit. All right, we give up.
Where they got the niggas from?
The niggas that they... The niggas that work for free.
Where they got them from?
Where they came from.
They went and got them. They brought them.
From where?
Not all the, I'm saying.
They got a lot of them.
They went and got a lot of them.
They got millions of niggas.
But they didn't get all of them.
They got a lot of them.
So you not saying that when you saying that.
Exactly.
So that's what I'm saying.
I did say that.
Wait, then. You said these niggas already there. Duh.
Okay.
Some nigga was here because we had boats too. They took our shit.
Okay.
But when niggas start losing their culture, start losing the spirit of the Almighty,
the culture is never lost.
Pagan gods,
the culture
shit.
They was doing the same shit that we doing right now.
It's already in the book.
The same gold and jewelry and shit that we celebrating, they did the same shit. They was extravagant niggas just like we sitting right here right now.
Man, some moose.
Come on, man.
But they were niggas.
They was niggas.
Show that. That's a good. That's
but they weren't.
Any person on earth knows.
But
that.
They weren't niggas because they knew exactly who the fuck they were. They knew the title. They knew where they came from. They knew the name of the people. We don't.
Because that's they were unified.
But that we don't mean that it changed for us. We still the same people just because we don't know our title. We don't know our label. We don't know our tribe
see,
or our kinsmen.
The reason why we're not gonna get together because we're not unified. Nobody wanna get unified. Niggas wanna say that was the past and this is now. You don't really give a fuck about. Brother,
but that's
that
what
brother,
I'm trying to explain
like,
to you.
This is it.
We were hey, never up, together, nigga. We looking at 1,000 tribes of motherfuckers in this room.
Facts.
You was the leader of your folks, and you were, the king, nigga. Everybody had their own shit.
But you know what we gotta do though. But you know what we gotta do though. Come together and get unified and really have a structure, bro. It's a plan. We got commandments. We got rules. We got all this. You dig what I'm saying? Cause we all the Hebrews. We all the real ones. You dig what I'm saying?
We don't, cause we have.
We don't have no doctrine.
We haven't
established that yet. We just waking up, doing what we want to do, thinking we can do what we want to do, thinking that we can just do it how we do it. Nope. That ain't how it goes.
That's why all these tragedies keep happening. Until we actually do that and sit down as a black people to say, this is too far.
And
we all feel like this.
You gotta stand on what's too far. That's how I feel like.
Right.
You know, I ain't no political or nobody like that, but I feel like nigga, you gotta stand on what he's saying and start showing some action to what he say. That's all, that's it. Nothing too much, no, you know what I'm saying?
Bro, I love doing this show because they gonna see this shit and be like, that nigga be hating. I don't give a fuck.
Nigga ain't hating on nothing else.
I just feel like we should be able
to. Real,
we can just debate and debate what the fuck we want to debate.
You know, yeah,
but that's the only way we. That's why I said earlier, I love these platforms that we got because we get to allow it. It shows that we get to talk.
This
to
is healthy black man conversation. This is shit that we talk about at the barbershop.
This shit's therapeutic, man.
It's flat at the top and round at the bottom.
What I say, I've been saying that. It's a sphere.
It's a sphere.
The herb got a little ass on it.
Yeah, got a little booty.
That's the
booty.
That's the biggest myth. That's the biggest lie in the world. They put the globe in front of you as in kindergarten. They got their pre-K. That shit flat as hell, man.
Science is beautiful, but they can't guess what? You can't overlook the real shit. The universe.
So
come on,
he said,
man.
I knew flat. They told me he did the bed trip.
It was flat. What'd
you get that quarter, spin that quarter. That motherfucker look like a ball because it's spinning so fast. That motherfucker flat. He spin that quarter. Look like a sphere.
Let me tell you something. Ain't no way in hell water.
Ain't no picture. Ain't no real picture. Show me a real picture.
I seen a waterfall.
Okay.
Show me a real picture.
The earth is this way. And water ain't just for the father to hit me in the face.
Nah, this the thing I don't know though. We arguing all this bullshit. The motherfucker could be a cube. Or a pentagon or a record. I don't know.
Ain't no
picture. Show me one real picture of the earth.
If you show me where one motherfucker ever fall off this bitch, I believe it.
Listen, man, show me one.
It's round, but it's a hole in the middle.
Can you fall off the earth?
Went out in space and came back. You know, nigga going to space. There's shit out there that ain't never coming back.
But I just came out of crew, man. That motherfucker too flat. I saw it.
What?
The earth.
The water. Yeah, my butt.
Bro, I done been on these flights.
That boy said it too flat.
Come on, bro. Too flat. Listen what I'm trying to tell you, bro.
I'm
listening. Show me one real picture of the earth. I ain't talking about no gold. Show me one real picture.
Ain't mountains in
if a nigga been to the moon, you gonna take that picture of the moon from the earth. Let me just take a picture of earth right
there. They call it scuba diver.
That's cap. Look, no, that's real. The scuba diver. Show me one real picture of the earth. Ain't that glow? That's man. Like that's just what people think. Somebody thought. Show me one real picture.
They keep saying that they finding other little planets.
I don't think nobody went to the moon.
Ain't nobody even add that one to none of the planets.
I don't think nobody went to the moon.
We ain't add none of them new planets.
I think that's cap, man.
We done found three planets. Shut the fuck up.
God ain't made the world for him.
They ain't
even been to the
moon, man. About that moon, man. That's cap, man.
They said water on Mars.
It's cap, man. They ain't been to that moon, man.
Flat on the moon.
Man, they dropped it with a drone.
I told you.
They dropped the flag with a drone.
You see this shit?
They dropped the flag with a drone.
Ain't no wind or what? On the moon?
Yeah.
And gravity ain't.
Ain't no wind in space. Man, that's a fake picture.
That's a fake picture, ain't it?
Nigga, bro, show me one
ain't
real
no
picture.
No one on Mars.
Show me one real picture of the Earth.
Where the fuck I'ma get it at?
They said UFO coming out.
The fuck
they said UFO coming out. Y'all believe in aliens? I don't believe no motherfucking alien shit. But if I seen a one-eyed motherfucker, and I done seen a one-eyed nigga, we got
that.
Bro,
I can't say that, though.
It's aliens, but the crazy part is, the part that's gonna fuck you up,
I can't say that, though.
It's humans that weren't born on Earth. Check this out. This is my theory on the aliens, right? Hold up, DC.
But they could be the aliens then.
Hold up.
Show that.
But they humans, but they like us. Yeah.
They look like it, but you feel
so you mean
me?
To tell me
gonna be some
they done flew over all these galaxies through all this space and avoided all these asteroids and meteorites and all this shit and crashed in the desert where ain't shit at?
Oh, you talking about Roswell, New Mexico?
That's the bullshit.
What?
I don't believe motherfuckers then flew over all these galaxies and crashed in the middle of nowhere.
So that story is supposed to be that the motherfuckers ain't really crashed.
They got shot
but they made contact with them motherfuckers. And they crashing with the way to cover up what the fuck they seen.
Shit,
bro, you
know
it been contact, bro. You can tell by the video people putting out.
I'm
you can't explain how light's going from this that bad.
Okay, if they
one
real.
Eye alien, I'm letting the whole world know. Hey, y'all gonna think I'm on cocaine then.
If they real, they smart enough to not fuck with us.
Right.
That's the crazy part about it.
Like, they know not because
bro,
they
just
know
Vegas,
effect
bro.
Not
when
to
I
get.
Was just
no,
Vegas.
They know we stupid. We too stupid right. To even fuck with.
What you see, they put that Area 51.
Yeah.
When I was just in Vegas, they said they got that, that's a real spot. They said it's a real spot.
Like, I feel like that's just where they keep all the comfort. Like the shit that's confidential and shit.
Like, bro, you know, like,
that's
man,
the
be
cap
on
that. Spot now that people right. Know about it. I think
yeah,
they just
yeah.
Keep that bitch going, but they got another, but they probably got air. Mm-hmm.
But shit, on the ground and shit, they and that testing look. But you seen Jurassic Park?
The word.
They got like them little bird, yeah, dinosaur.
Why you do that?
Long ass nigga. Yeah, he like a, that's how you look, that nigga came over like a little ostrich. I was like, this shit foul. He hit that nigga, he slapped me. I said, this nigga got that head. I said, well, I fuck with Jurassic Park.
So they done gave the dinosaurs feathers,
man. But they done gave the nigga, it's an ostrich dinosaur with some fingernail, nigga. He had that slapping the dinosaur. G-Red came on, he said, shut up. He was like,
all right, I'm going. Man, look at the shit y'all in here talk about today, man.
Crazy.
Hey, Clayton English. You ordering all your summer essentials with Dash Pass by DoorDash? You need to. It's a great way to get everything you need. And during the summer of Dash Pass, you can save money and access members-only offers that will help you feel easy and breezy all summer long. Say hello to summer savings during the summer of Dash Pass from DoorDash. With $0 delivery fees, exclusive items, and more than 25,000 members only offers nationwide, Dash Pass by DoorDash has everything you need to make your summer memorable. With members only offers and items dropping every week, you'll have everything you need to make the most out of your summer right at your fingertips. That's 50% off your first order up to $15 in value when you sign up for DoorDash during summer of Dash Pass. Using promo code 85SOUTH2022. With your Dash Pass by DoorDash membership, you can save an average of $4 to $5 on every order you place for delivery or pickup. That means on average, Dash Pass pays for itself when you order just twice a month. Shine bright during DoorDash's Summer of Dash Pass and get 50% off your first order up to $15 in value. Use promo code 85SOUTH2022 at checkout when you spend $12 or more. Don't forget, that's code 85SOUTH2022 for 50% off your first order up to $15 in value. Dash Pass benefits only on eligible orders that meet the minimum subtotal. Terms apply.
Guys, it's time to bring that summer heat into the bedroom. That's right. This episode is sponsored by Blue Chew, guys. Hey, Blue Chew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra and Cialis, but in chewable tablets and at a fraction of the cost. The best part, it's all done online. So no visits to the doctor's office, no awkward conversations, and no waiting in line at the pharmacy. Confidence can take you far in life. It can also help in the bedroom, especially when it's time to step up to the plate. That's where Blue Chew comes in. You can take them anytime, day or night, so you can plan ahead or be ready whenever an opportunity arises. The process is simple. Sign up at BlueChew.com. consult with one of the licensed medical providers, and once you're approved, you'll receive your prescription within days. Blue Chew's tablets are made in the USA and prepared and shipped in a discreet package straight to your door. So if you can benefit from extra confidence when it's time to perform, Blue Chew can help. And we've got a special deal for our listeners. Try Blue Chew for free when you use promo code 85SOUTH at checkout. Just pay $5 shipping. That's BlueChew.com, promo code 85SOUTH to receive your first month free. Visit BlueChew.com for more important safety details and information. And we thank Blue Chew for sponsoring the podcast. Hey, man, welcome back to the 85 South Show.
Yeah.
This shit done went a whole nother direction, bro. We been talking about flat earth to everything. Yeah. We ain't said shit about no music.
That my shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's your shit.
Nah, just like what we were talking about, that was just hard. Like, that was just fine. That was
we just go off escape. Like that sometimes.
That was just fine little escape.
Yeah, we're gonna keep the conversation yeah, going. You know I'm gonna always say some niggas in here.
I'm definitely happy to music, man. I got, what type of music, what you wanna talk about?
Shit, where you wanna start from? You said start from the beginning, and one of your favorite joints was Nigga Don't Get No Sleep No More.
Nigga Don't Get No Sleep No More. I feel like he dropped that motherfucker right now.
What's the story behind that?
Oh man, story behind that, man. My nigga TJ was living there, man. I was at the studio every day then, man. Had just got out of jail. At the studio every day, man. Working on my craft, trying to get better, recording myself. Yeah, bro. Everybody coming up, living in that motherfucker.
How long you was in jail?
15 months.
Was you in there with a nigga who was rapping like hell?
Hell nah. It was a nigga in the dorm rapping yeah, like hell, but
when I get home.
I turned to him.
For real?
I turned to him like within like probably like 5 months, 6 months in. I turned to him like within 6 months in. But at first I wasn't trying to do that because in my mind I'm going home.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But nah man, my motherfucking roommate had one with schizo. That shit was so crazy.
Yeah, I had one too. He tripped out. He was coming off alcohol. Nigga was on alcohol for like 3 days. And what they call that when that shit be detoxing? Nigga coming out of their body.
Withdrawal.
Yeah, the withdrawal. Man, nigga thought he was moving the dough. He was like, help me, bro. My son out there. I said, but yes. I'm like, man. 2 o'clock in the morning, man. Y'all got to come get this nigga, bro.
That nigga said his son out there.
He said, my son out there, come move the toe for me. I'm like, man, you got it.
I'm like, that nigga got to tell a story late at night. And I just knew, like, chill out tonight, bro. Yeah. You know, like, I'm starting that shit tonight, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Put that nigga up tonight, man. You know what I'm saying? Put that nigga in your back pocket, man. I'm starting that nigga tonight, man. You know what I'm saying? Mom, do something come this weekend. I don't want to hear that nigga today, bro. Man, I'm sorry, he might get the whisper.
I couldn't do that shit. Because you don't know who the fuck gonna show up. He's got motherfuckers in his head. Johnny wants to stay up tonight. Who the fuck is Johnny?
That's
not
playing at first, man. My nigga cat. He's trying to kite out.
He's trying to get
out
of here.
Man, that motherfucker kept going about 80 days. That nigga slow.
Mm-mm.
He's
going
through it.
I know that nigga
gonna
start eating.
He just eat.
Got out, started doing shit, started popping it. Going crazy. When did you know that it was like, oh shit, oh this shit, it changing now?
Probably when I first booked my first show in Tennessee.
Right.
From Mondo House on MySpace.
On MySpace?
Yeah, MySpace. Nah, this ain't MySpace. It's Twitter.
Twitter.
I went back with Tony.
Yeah,
no.
Crazy. I was like, nigga, you were nine on MySpace.
Yeah.
Man,
stupid.
This nigga was hustling early, nigga.
Had background song and everything.
Let's get deep. Yeah. Let's get deep. Yeah. You know, man, I'm from the A. I'm from the West Side. Now, when they was saying that, you was sounding like Future. Yeah. When you, ooh, they saying you taking the Future sauce. I'm like, no, sir. Now, he handling his business. Everybody can be influenced, but he has his own style.
What's up?
What made you stay focused and be like, you know what, I'm gonna show these motherfuckers. Me, Homie Quan. Stop playing.
Shit, that's all I knew.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I wasn't faking it. I definitely wasn't trying to sound like bro.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I don't even see that comparison, really. I think.
Nah, I can see it at first just from the, you know, like, weren't too many people just rapping like that at first.
But then you had somebody came out sound just like him.
But that was different.
That's what I'm saying.
That was like, right. I studied you, copied your cadence. Like, that's different.
Yeah.
That's obsessed. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
That was weird. You know what I'm saying? This one that though. And I think you can just tell from the from the catalog.
Yeah, definitely.
Like, I went, like, it wasn't never that. Even it's just like, even now, man, me and Future probably got man, probably about 10 unreleased songs.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that be the beauty of it. You know what I'm saying? How, you know, when you get old, you just look at shit like, damn, people are really trying to make that song.
Right.
When you get old, you're like, man, that wasn't nothing.
Right.
Especially like with me and bro right now.
Right.
You feel me? That be the beauty of it.
Pop.
That's crazy.
Just supposed to let that shit sit for a minute.
Yeah. But what's crazy is, like, in the midst of all that, like, we had did this show together. And man, bro, I swear to God, coming back, I might have been in, my seat was 2A. Why that nigga seat 2B? I just talked the whole flight.
Yeah.
Talked the whole flight.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, nah, I'm gonna sit y'all nigga down here. Just talk. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all can control this nigga.
Yeah, for sure that.
Yeah, that's
how people was trying to do that. They want to control y'all to start some shit. Like, oh, look, they both, they getting hot right now. Why y'all trying to call commotion?
You know that was a good thing about Atlanta, though. A lot of times, it seemed like y'all, right. y'all would sort that shit out.
And it'd be more so what people create opposed to. You don't even know the person that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Atlanta really smart.
Yeah, people put shit on you, then put shit on another motherfucker. Oh,
they can really be connected on the low for real. If you make a phone call, you be like, okay, we do know some mutual people. Yeah, like,
you gonna always family. Know somebody who knows
somebody.
Yeah.
If you really from the city, you gonna know some damn about it.
Yeah, for sure that.
No cap.
You know what I'm saying?
But we got the music right now. They hot. Ain't
it. It's the last 20 years.
Yeah, it ain't
slow. I don't see it going nowhere no time soon.
You was a big part of that too. You held that torch for a little. Yeah.
You stood in front of the club.
Good run.
You stood in front of that old ass apartment in front by down there.
That's by the AU. Yeah. Over there.
But
by
see, Atlanta is the capital of the culture though.
Real talk. You know, Black Hollywood.
It's where the culture is. It's the first and the last stop, man.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We get on it first. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We're on the front. We're gonna let you know we're digging it or dishing it, like literally.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because like when you go like, and I know y'all probably can attest to this, like, but being on that road, you just see how slow other spots are. And nothing, and I ain't gonna say them other spots.
It's the difference with Atlanta, like though. It's like, you don't have to look for the black people in Atlanta.
Yeah.
Every other city, you gotta go like.
What the heck?
Exactly.
Yeah. See, we so black. I didn't know that. I didn't know that until people come out here and be like, "By Lord, saw what y'all niggas so black." I'm like, "Nigga, it ain't like that everywhere."
Nope.
Like y'all just
laying
next to people you don't know.
Yes.
No.
It don't look like you.
Yes.
No. Yeah.
I been around black motherfuckers. My whole life.
Tuck your wife.
Number me, but what? Clock your
call.
Doors.
Yeah, exactly. Make sure yeah,
you
call
got number loved ones. Lock your doors. Make get your purse. Out. Tuck it.
And that's just the way we grew up. That's the culture. That's Atlanta.
In fact.
That's Atlanta. You got to be ready for that.
See, I ain't used to that.
You wouldn't leave door unlocked.
Yeah,
door like nobody.
Nigga,
nobody.
You come outside, nigga, in your car. Oh, did you? Oh,
no.
Oh.
Sleeping bag.
Get out my shit, man.
Oh, sleeping bag and everything.
Get your ass out.
You'll get, they ain't even gotta worry about shit like that in Mississippi.
What part of the ship you from?
I'm from Oxford.
Ain't nobody gonna fuck with your shit.
David Banner, where you from?
Jackson.
Yeah.
David Banner, man, I ain't gonna lie, David Banner put that motherfucker, like, he represent.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie.
I ain't even no motherfucker.
Shout out David Banner.
Shout out to him. He producing. I thought that made it even more dope.
So. Yeah. Him been big to
create. But I'm coming back.
Big that Rick Ross
here. Yeah.
Hey, how you gonna put a Rick Ross
here?
That a Rick Ross.
Man. Nah, him and Big Crit, they be putting on for us musically, man. Them my Rick niggas. He about to drop some new shit. The God Box 2.
Hey, Ray Sermon down
there? Yeah, Two Below. I was gonna get down the list.
Oh, okay.
We got a few now, man.
Yeah.
We got a few. A lot of motherfuckers about to be coming out of Mississippi, man.
I don't know what they like at the time, like, you going back to that rubber band, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He a fool on that production, man.
Listen, that's what I'm saying. So I felt like he had, like, that advantage already. You feel me?
Yeah.
Even with Crit, like, I like how into him Crit is with it, too.
Yeah. I like how he incorporate the old shit.
Yeah, like. You just tell you a fan of hip-hop.
Yeah,
that's like when I listen to it, like you can just tell like he a fan of it. Like,
yeah, yeah.
He
cares. You can tell.
Like, it's different when you can listen to somebody's music and tell he cares.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Who you been fucking with on the new shit?
On the new shit, man.
Just on them songs. I'm saying just not the artist, just straight songs.
Who I been listening to?
Just songs that you like.
Songs that I like. I ain't gonna lie, man. I like the way Dirk put it together.
Yeah.
I like the way Dirk put it together. You know what I'm saying? But I ain't gonna lie, man. Baby song, baby putting on for the city.
Hell yeah. That's, yeah, that's just a good look, too.
That's hard. That's hard, but like, if I'm just listening to music.
Yeah.
I told you that was coming back.
Okay.
Oh, let me ask you this. What about some of these the female rappers, man? You heard anything that stuck with you?
That girl got it just signed. On the song, everybody sang.
Yeah.
Only part, the men came, like the FR.
It's just good to see the women have something they can enjoy.
Yeah, for sure. All the women, like, the women take this to another level.
Yeah. 4.5 years, what you mean? Finally.
I'm saying, it's good to see them have that lane where they can have music that they can enjoy exclusively amongst the girls. Them, yeah, I don't want to see niggas mess up everything.
Facts.
They still ain't had one where they can 100% just let them have that.
Right,
don't even lie, though, man.
They need that.
Somebody got to just really turn up with the R&B, because that was missing, man.
Need Summer Walker?
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's cool, but you know what I'm saying? We just
got
to...
Ari Lennox, we got some dope R&B motherfuckers.
What type of R&B, like, bringing it back, like Drew Hill?
Yeah, but R&B don't get that push, man.
I'm just saying, like, it just don't get as much. Like, you don't
get the light on.
It's in the back seat. It's an ad lib right now. You know what I'm saying?
Joe.
You know what I mean? I'm just like, I'm not, but I'm just being honest, bro.
All right, let's find some R&B artists then. We're gonna find some R&B artists.
Some are walking hard, but what I'm saying is,
it's a lot of them new. A lot of them
new. You want some of that like, because us is like,
he different.
Hey, like, CB, like, we need some more of those. Like,
they out here. We got to do a better job of finding and supporting them, though.
Don't worry about it. Wait till y'all see these videos.
They out here.
We gotta just do it different, you know. We gotta just be careful what we call talent, man.
Hey,
man. A lot of this stuff not talent.
It's just viral.
I'm about to start me a record label,
you know what I'm saying?
It's viral commotion. That's what I call it.
Yeah. Listen,
I
want you on my record label.
What you say?
We're gonna do. Listen. I want you on my record label. Look, we're a small company. This is what we're gonna do, baby. We're gonna give you $3,500 up front. Okay?
25.
All right, we do $2,500 advance. That's on your first album. Now, your first album ain't gonna have but 5 songs on them. You own some of that, and I own most of that because I put up the money. It was my studio. See, listen, you're gonna get exposure off of this one.
Your first album gonna be a compilation.
Now, see, we're kind of like an incubator.
You're gonna be featured on your album.
It's like a pre-record label. It's just to get you in shape. We're just going to get you in shape for the record label, baby.
You like the name? We own that, too.
Nah.
Cap, boy, yeah, I think it's stupid.
I'm going to find some motherfucking artists, though, man. That's what the world been missing.
Well, shit, they're done. I mean, the time done.
I know. Bro.
I'm proud of you. The city proud of you. We're waiting on you. And you know it ain't too many people like... The city be like, love and want to hear music constantly, like, sure. Forever.
Right.
Once they get over, they over. Yeah. Niggas ain't never got over. Niggas still rocking with you, bro. Like, none stop. You
and that's the most.
You started all this shit. Nigga can't fuck with you, man.
I left with unturned page, man. I'm just about to turn the page over, show niggas what it is. You know what I'm saying? It ain't about. Because don't nobody really care about what I did. It's about what I'm about to do, what I'm doing.
Right.
So that's where I'm at, man. The new music gonna speak for itself, bro. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, after the new music drop, man, you gonna be like, oh. It was homie just be, you know, say what he say.
So you say.
I'm more like, you know, show and prove, like, the rap game. I'm gonna let my music talk for itself.
You want to know what? I want to tell you, you speak for a lot of people. Mm-hmm. A lot of people need you.
For sure. That. You know the voice. The voice
they need
for a lot
you.
Of people.
So sometimes the urgency, you gotta understand your purpose is bigger than what you may feel like, what you going through.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? So it's like,
preaching me.
Them folk, they need that shit. Them folk need that shit.
Yeah.
Because this is the only way they can be chill. This is the only way they can goddamn go out here and maneuver and have their business. You got these niggas listening to other folk, they don't even want to listen to.
Right. And like you said, the rap, it ain't just rap. Don't just rap, make music.
For sure.
Music is what connect. They'll hear the rap, but it's the music, man. You make a good overall product.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, man. I treat them like my babies. Everybody know that. Like, man, I'm procured by every song, like down to the instrumental I pick, down to the rhyming words I use. Like, I don't even want to use the same rhyming words as these niggas. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how different I want to get in my bag. You know how you can hear a nigga rap, you know he finna rhyme with.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Go back in it. Get back in the gym.
That's why I'm aggressive. I want to see the passion in nigga when they rap. I believe it better. Listen. I don't want you to sit up and be like, oh, you can rap. Everybody can rap and spit a flow, but can you make a motherfucker believe
it? For sure, that's different.
I get the chills when I'm like, yeah, that's what I want to feel. But nigga, don't give me the chill. Fuck it. That's some pussy ass shit. You ain't for real. I don't feel it.
Don't care. I didn't mention this song earlier, but My Nigga, My Nigga.
Yeah. Come on, man.
I feel like as a nigga, that's one of them anthems. I feel like I want them to dig that song up and play it in 50 years.
That's one-on-one, though.
Yeah. We needed that one.
And y'all flipping, your I feel like a good radio version. Right.
What I'm saying, a nigga, your big friend.
Yeah.
Man, that's my dog, man. My nigga. You gotta say it twice.
That's Jackson State theme song.
For sure that not, man. You know, we tried to get Dion, man. I tried to turn up with the team, man. We tried to get out there with Dion, man.
He'll get it together.
What you waiting on?
Once soon as he see it, he gonna be over with.
Oh yeah, come on, Prime.
It's over with Prime time.
No, I'm
linking up. Get what's so crazy, man. I got Prime picture painted in my house, man. I might have painted
it. I'm gonna link you up with him.
Yeah, Prime, man, I just wanted to paint a picture at the crib, man. You know what I'm saying? I paid like $15,000 for this picture painted to Prime, man. You know, he was the biggest influence in growing up on sports. Like, that's why I played baseball, because of Dion.
Really?
Nah, no bullshit.
That's crazy.
Man, we got to make that.
We got to make that.
See, niggas don't understand all that is in the package. Y'all done gave me millions, but I got to go out here and work for this shit.
But see, that's the thing that, like, I think black athletes don't get to hear enough of. Yeah. It's because it's like, they playing sports, not knowing that. That shit is influencing a lifestyle.
You get to build that. You can really turn it into some shit.
Those influences carry on. It goes like even beyond sports. Everything that we do as black men is going like we want to add some flair to it.
You get what I'm saying?
Like,
it's a lot of people that play NBA, but you don't know them because they ain't got no fucking sauce.
Yeah. Right.
Y'all niggas ain't got no sauce. Y'all just got to get some sauce.
Like I saw Deion say, man, like a lot of these kids don't play baseball, and that's the highest paying sport, bro.
Yeah.
And it's like the most savings. You ain't worrying about no concussion.
But you got to see the other part. He got a new one where he said they priced the black kids out of the game. Where it's like,
yeah, exactly. Like baseball, all you needed was
a bat and a glove when they was coming.
Now it's fees on
you got to be on traveling team.
You got to pay like $3,000 to pay. See a game.
Right.
Get with them, man. That kid got it, but for what they paying.
What?
And they just offer, what they just offer that boy Soto? 440 million, man.
Just hit a couple home runs.
Man, Soto just won. He just won the home run derby last night.
Ooh.
And he turned it down.
What are you doing?
15 years, though.
Huh?
40 million.
Somebody give me a number so I can call him. I don't give a damn how many years. That's 15 years.
This would be a great.
That's a long commitment, though. Yeah. That's a long commitment in Washington.
This would be a great time to tell
you. It's a long commitment in Washington.
Because what if you can get 200 from one spot for a shorter deal or 300 and then get another?
What Freddie Freeman just got? 140 for 5 years? For 5 years? For 4 years.
Freddie Freeman had to buy his agent. That shit crazy. That man ain't even tell that nigga. That's fucked up.
It would be a great time to tell all the young viewers to look up Collective Bargaining.
All the motherfucking merch money. I want all the. That ain't no money for 450.
What you making a year? What are you making a year?
I see what you're saying. Break it down.
But how much?
You can get two
in 15 years.
In 15 years,
you
got to do a calculator.
What What it like 400 by 15?
Yeah, they tried to trick that man.
What it is?
What dude from who played with the Padre? He just signed some shit for like 12 years. Yeah, Machado, what his name? Machado? What else?
Is he the fastest or he just
hitting that ball.
How old he is?
He just like 21?
He
like 23.
Oh, no, hell no, he got young life. Yeah,
man. Baseball.
Ain't nobody getting baseball. No 700 million in no goddamn baseball, man. That shit
he
crazy.
Young as hell.
I saw it.
Yeah.
Came in second place.
You know what I'm saying? My boy Darius Schroeder, man, that nigga, they off that nigga 31. He was like, all right, I'm going to give you two. And I was like, oh. I know that shit had my boy heart like, oh, Lord. I can't believe
it.
I would have slapped the shit out my agent. Not my agent. Now, I think I love them, but I'm talking about my sports agent. I would have slapped the dog doo-doo out of that.
How much you got?
Who?
How much you got?
About a 2P. They be like, oh, you don't want to take the 31? All right. I gave you
2. 31 million to 2 million?
Boy, yes.
Who?
Oh, my head come rap for me.
Oh, yeah.
I was so hurt for my boy. I said, ooh, because I thought when he turned around, I was like, okay, they going to bump. They were like, what?
They my boy.
Bet, 2 million. Oh, Lord. I can't go back to the other one. Oh, Lord. And he was worth it too. He worked that 30.
70.
And one no other team trying to give him even a 60.
Everybody else making down there 40, 50 a year.
Yeah, that's true.
I love baseball. I don't care what you're talking about.
I'm gonna tell you.
I don't know. They like 90 games.
What's 162 games?
Oh, they make them boys worth it.
I know
shit.
I love baseball.
That
yeah.
Should be back to back to back.
Yeah,
that's them too, regular right? Seasons. Don't fuck around and make the playoffs.
That happened a year. Yeah, you still got to practice.
Yeah.
No, fuck around and make the playoffs.
How many games you got, bro? You got to think they down there have 3 games a week. Something. But I'm saying on the average, 3.
I love
3 at a minimum.
I don't love that shit that much.
And you playing at the hottest goddamn time.
Dude, what? C game?
400 million bucks.
Sign me up, Cup. You look like I'm having a heat stroke out here. But I don't care about.
Hey.
Bring me some water.
I'm glad when you look, though, bro.
You got to get used to it. Tell the truth, bro. When you playing baseball and you losing, that seems like that's the longest game in the goddamn world.
You don't even know what you're doing. You just got that. Now you thinking like him. Playing baseball. I might have sweating. So I know me.
Give him the broom, bro. That's the basis, though.
Nah, that shit is boring if you don't know what's going on.
Right.
You got to think that's something I played from 4 to 18.
I told him about good, bro.
I played from 4 to 18, bro.
Yeah.
That's all I knew.
We went to the same little all-star shit. The sign, oh, you remember that little summer camp shit? You was at? That way he knew I could play baseball. When he see me, he was like, Lil John, you okay?
Yeah, for
okay,
sure.
Okay, I see you, Lil John. I'm like, yeah, only the Greeks come out here, buddy.
Nah, that shit was cool. I ain't gonna lie, man, that shit was like cool. But cause like I learned so much shit like in baseball that I still use in my everyday life.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Teamwork. I mean, like.
You ready?
You know what I mean?
What position?
Center field, baby.
Center field.
Yeah. My batting got sorry as fuck. No, I got better on defense. I got trash.
When I got high school, my shit got five. My last year, like, power ball, my shit was ass. I struck out, like, every time. Like,
what's your best game? Your whole baseball career?
Man, I had it one game in high school, bro. We playing the white boys. I'm like, we on that win.
Right.
At night, man. Lights on in nighttime game.
Nighttime game.
You know what I'm saying? One of them, boy.
Bing.
Take out. Only thing I can get, nobody look like Andrew Jones. Shoot, die. Bing, hit my face. Get up, throw it straight to home.
He's out.
Win with that play right there.
Yeah. Good luck.
Man,
what you doing?
Like
me? That's all I got. I got one,
too. Hey, look. With the bitch, bro. Man, I swear to God, bro. That shit felt so good.
I got one throw. I got
one. Yeah, you stretched out for that bitch. You hit your face.
Like,
back
you know, my mama like, that's my baby.
Yeah.
No, mama get on after I do it.
Like, that's fine.
That shit felt so good. You know what I'm saying? After that,
you knew you were good, dude. That's certified.
I'm going to Fort Valley.
Yeah.
For a week.
Stupid.
Back at the house.
Look at the
glove. Look, that was so crazy. Shit, my little boy got a glove. They got glove balls and stuff. So that's what it's about, showing them.
Yeah.
And let him make that decision. Because 162 games is a lot of games, but I wouldn't mind if I didn't pay 400 million.
400 million, please, son.
You know what I'm saying?
I can't wait to see my son do something.
Whatever, you know what I'm saying?
Especially if they like
you.
But I'll be so turnt. Yeah. I just don't want to be sorry. No sport. That's gone. I don't know.
But like, get what? It don't change though. You know, you can just go get them boy to train and stuff.
Yeah, but if he's sorry, I don't know how to talk shit about a sorry ass player.
Nah, you can't. You got to, cause it's on. If he's sorry, that means you sorry.
No, it ain't nothing. That nigga just.
I'm telling you.
He's
like, one thing I done learned. Like,
my dad ain't never played no sport. I don't know. Yeah, all me. Daddy, church shoes.
One thing I know.
He get out there and slip on that cut. It's a rap for pop.
I know too. Hey, but
you
look,
know what I'm saying?
But like, man, with them kids, man, they so more advanced than us, bro.
Yeah.
Like, they so way more advanced than us. You'll be surprised, man. Like,
my little nephew,
they own little people already. Right. It's like, once they get here, it's like they got their own agenda and shit.
Right.
You can try like hell, but they are who they gonna be.
Right.
That's the surprising part about being a parent, man. Just watching these little personalities develop.
That shit's fun. And stuff you want them to do, and you want to find out.
They got their own interests, and it's like the shit that you on. They be like, yeah, that's cool.
You can see you and them so much. Though, like,
they'll never be into what like you into.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Why
you get that little boy? You gonna
I know the tap dancer. I used to tap dance. I said, yeah, look just like me out there.
Yeah. It's dope, man.
That's fact. She love this shit.
That's too hard.
That making noise.
That's too hard.
Come watch me, daddy. Click, 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 click. I'm like, go ahead. Do your shit. But that shit, I'm telling you. My little nephew athletic, though. Them niggas out there running track and shit. Like, you see the little nigga posture stuff. I'm like, okay.
They gonna be bigger than
can't
me.
Wait.
I'm trapping over, boy.
Huh?
That nigga said, nigga gonna be bigger. They gonna be bigger than us.
I can't wait, boy. My little nigga gonna be, boy, that nigga can't do no
got,
wrong in my
life. You gotta see my son. You gotta see my oldest son.
Okay.
You gotta see my oldest son.
I be watching this dude, too. As long as it ain't gonna hurt him.
Yeah.
My oldest son bigger than me and you, man.
That shit crazy, bro. We getting old, bro. We was just in middle school. He finna be in middle school. They gonna go by fast.
My oldest son gonna be in high school this year, man.
No cap!
But he bigger than me and you, man.
Yo, hold on.
My oldest son.
Damn. Okay,
14.
Man, that's it. My son big as hell, man.
You been crying.
My son tall as a motherfucker. I might have to help him find his real daddy.
You stupid. Stupid. Shut up.
That nigga love stupid, man. Hey, that nigga
shut your
stupid.
Ass up, bro. You stupid.
My thing.
You stupid. Nah, all you gotta do is look at your kid pictures, nigga.
You told him that?
Yeah. Hey, man, I don't know you. Hey, man, you exceeding all group expectations around here, bro. Feet bigger than mine and everything, right, hey, man? You finna have to pay some bills, bro. This is motherfucking dog.
What is funny, bro?
He's
on plan. He's on plan, but he's
son, niggas a motherfucking bro.
My son just graduated 8th grade, man.
But that's
man,
funny, bro.
Man, 12, man.
Hey, my son going to the 8th grade and well 13. He already at the dumbass size. He had to get his shoes off that motherfucker with them 6 shoes on that bitch. That's all. That's
what
it.
Nigga dumb in hell,
them motherfucker got some. Them motherfucker got some white Air Force One. Some of them Team Jordans, New Balance. Yeah,
that's it. They ain't got too many of them. Bruh, I know 13.
13.
What?
Well, my son is 12 in 8th grade.
Man,
that's hilarious, bro.
No, it's not.
But that's why you got to get him checked.
You know what I'm saying? Once you get to 13, nigga, it ain't before 5 options in this bitch, bro.
Man.
It's
over. I'm gonna get my nigga. I'm gonna get my arm. That nigga don't, he can't even wear my shit now. My sweater, that nigga, my sweater about to stop right here. He gotta get that shit back. He like, I can't fit in no more. I'm like, all right, cause I want that sweater anyway then.
That parenting shit crazy, bro.
But you know, I got a good heart, so I gave it to you.
Get it back.
Get it
back. Get it
back. I put it in the clear to get it back.
Come on, man.
No cap.
Come on, man.
Hand me down, hand me up, get it back.
You ever want to surprise yourself, go back and look at some pictures of when you was a kid and then figure out how old your parents were when you were that age. That shit gonna blow your mind. You're like,
Reebok.
These motherfuckers, we don't even know if they was really responsible or they, or like, we was just even, kids and we thought they were.
Hey, I can't even see how my mom and my dad
that was balled up. You know how
I can't even see it.
You know how the tip of your shoe be balled up?
That shit be blowing my mind too. Like, I know my dad.
Yeah, like.
How the fuck he pulled my mom?
And then great.
My mama a nice lady. He a nigga.
Pa had that game.
She don't do no wrong.
Pa from
right. This nigga pa, do pa everything.
Pa from silk.
Hell yeah.
Pa from pimp. You know, miss shipping on pimp.
Man.
My mama pretty here. She just like my daughter. Oh yeah, back. Ooh, what? My mama fine here.
Hold on, what?
Nah, no cap. Your mama beautiful.
My mom, I ain't gonna sit here and say she ain't beautiful.
Like, but. No cap. Like, you
just said, I'm gonna say that. You said,
I think everybody, but my mom was Miss Fulton.
My mom was Miss Bubbling Brown Sugar. And if you from Atlanta, you know it, Mar Brown, Miss Bubbling Brown Sugar.
What's her name?
Miss Bubbling Brown Sugar.
My mom ain't had no screen name. My mom was a nice, beautiful lady. That's it. My mom was an angel. They wrote church songs about my mom.
Yeah, she was. Now, that's what they gave the lead North Star Rick in the band.
What was it?
Mint Bubbling Brown Sugar.
Yeah, we love mama, man. Mama. Oh,
no cap.
Man.
I
love mama.
My mom used to talk so much shit, bro.
But your mama, bro, she's so fun. Coming out all the honor program lit. If I'm going to sit at anybody's table, I'm going to sit with them. No cap. We lit.
Shout out to all the mothers around the world.
Shout out to all the mothers, especially mine.
Hell yeah, all the mothers, love man.
Especially my mama. Yeah, she's
mamas
so
don't get enough credit, bro.
Shout out to you too, Nanny. Love my Nanny too, man. My grandma.
All the women.
For sure, all the women.
Because everybody got their auntie that's your other mama too.
Come on,
no
man.
Cap.
You got
one. Or your homeboy mama.
You don't know what's going on.
Or your homeboy mama that loves you. Like, come on, man.
Or a candle lady love me
like
she might.
Like, come on, man.
You don't even know what type of relationship it is. A candle lady,
man, me bunny. Love me like
a that's the thing that take that shit to the next level, bro. When like, if you can eat over their house,
you fine.
That's your you real
know,
family.
How many days though? Cause you know I overstay my welcome. I'm there like 3 days. One plate they had me over here for all weekend, bro.
Nah, if you over there, they just feed you
a nigga
plate.
Like me.
You ain't
like,
ask for nothing.
Home. My mama said I can't come back home.
All right. I used to ask, my buddy, like, for one reason, my mom, we never get eye cream. My buddy, Maceo, I used to always get the eye cream.
Going stupid.
I'm like, man, come on, they got some of the eye cream. Y'all got some of the eye cream left. I got some of the eye cream left. They give me a whole bucket. They probably scooped it one time. But you was loaded, man. Come
if
on,
you had Eggos in your freezer, I always thought y'all were rich.
For real?
Egg on waffle. I'd be like, ooh, they rich. They got waffles. We had waffles and
you mean toast?
Had like sardines and shit.
Oh no, man.
I swear. Oh, the cat, you be like, man, eat them bitches piled up too. You like, man, I don't want to.
We had them noodles.
Yeah.
We didn't have noodles, we had sardines.
I believe that's why I'm a comedian now, bro.
That toast ain't gonna lie, that toast did some bread, nigga.
I used to do shit like that.
When you ain't got shit.
My mama used to get up and go to work before we left to go to school, and I'd be like, hey, mom, make some waffles in the morning so I can grab one and run out the door like I'm in a hurry. And she'd do that shit.
I'm gonna tell you what time you up.
Like the sitcom, man.
Right.
My mama start working at night.
That's what turned it up.
Out of there. I'm out the house.
She working at night?
I'm gone.
Street life.
Doing whatever I want to do.
The window.
Street life.
Come on, man.
Come on, man.
My mama knew she couldn't. But I went to high school. I told my mama, you not coming in my school. You can't work at this school. Oh, I'm not going to school. You crazy. I did that shit in middle school. That shit was traumatizing.
Jump through the window.
How old were you by then?
I'm like ninth grade.
So that way you really got outside.
I'm a new student at Matt now. So I'm a new. I went from
anything
the APS.
New,
I went from Bryce. I went from the APS.
Oh, you did go on the east side.
I went to Matt now. So then I'm a new student over there. So you know, like new student, I'm a new guy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's fun being a new guy. When you got that song, I'm like, ooh.
I'm the new
every
guy.
Every step you take, everybody feel it.
Boom. So like, boom.
Yeah, they go to new nigga. Boom. All the whole nigga. Yeah. Oh, you lost. You lost. You always lost.
High school, we don't know, man. That was like, that shit shaped me.
What changed the game, though, is like high school getting a driver's license. Boy, when motherfucker, like, high school was cool, right? And then it's like.
I didn't get my shit in high school.
Man, motherfucker.
My mom was straight driving.
Everything I could. Long as I get them like, what? Yeah, I had my learning for like 3 years.
I had to learn. I ain't never get my regular license in high school.
Shit, 3 years to the max. Then yeah. I jumped and got my real license.
That was the game. That's what changed everything right there.
Nigga, my buddy was driving. Then nigga had a car at 15, bro. So I was like, what are he?
Oh, yeah.
I wouldn't even stand no license.
We riding.
Man, we picking up. You know how it then, like, you pull up to school with your boy. Man, we smoking. Nigga, first day of school, nigga, we get pulled over, man. We get pulled over smoking first day of school, boy. First day of school, boy, they pulled a call. That when I find out, that when I knew my nigga be snitching.
Damn. What?
Nigga, boy, they like fours in the car. Boy, these niggas, like, these niggas are handcuffed. I'm like, get out of these handcuffs, I'm gonna beat your ass. I'm gonna beat you. I ain't got no handcuffs on me, man. You know, I done really slick got away, man. They done told me to make me come back in the office. My nigga done started crying. Like, man, I ain't going back to jail, man. You here.
Damn.
Damn. Just like that, in front of the floor. Walked you in, they were like, it was real. Who?
There he is. Oh.
Nah.
I didn't want to point that video.
Every step I take, every move I make.
Nah, we were tired.
No cap.
Damn.
When I started smoking, it was like, fuck baby. I couldn't even focus on baby.
Jumped out the foot then.
I'm in practice high.
Wow. Can't do that.
Playing tricks on the nigga while he high, boy. Yeah. I'm just gonna go to practice high.
That's the fucked up part about playing.
You ever go baseball.
But you still
can't play baseball high.
You cannot play baseball.
I can play basketball high. I can play basketball high.
That ain't you gonna lose. Yeah.
Not baseball, you can hoop high. Not no baseball.
You can hoop high.
Nah, niggas are leaving itself when you're out on the court. I'm in the outfield.
That ball's something different. You think it to the left, but that bitch to the right, my boy.
You looking at a fly ball high?
No,
try.
You can't.
Try.
Cause you gonna lose that bitch in the lights. And try.
You gonna lose it looking at it.
Yeah.
You tripping. You like, you see it, but you don't see it. That bitch coming faster than what it looked like. That bitch say,
you was like, all right, I can't smoke it and play baseball.
I'ma just smoke.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? At this point, I'm like, man, I'm gonna just smoke, man.
But you was still good, though.
I'm good, but bro, you know, you got to think, but I'm just looking at this point, I'm so older. I'm looking at, boy, ain't no really black men in the MLB. I'm looking at the black Sammy Sosa. Man, he Dominican Republic. Yeah, right. The people I think black ain't black.
He ain't
black
no more.
He
that nigga
Sammy Sosa.
But
he a Dominican.
Yeah,
nigga.
Light
lighter than you.
And
that nigga
turned
himself.
I don't even know what color that is. They ain't
you don't know what color that is?
That nigga is ham sandwich pimp now.
That boy
is
turkey meat. No, that boy
look
like turkey meat.
Listen,
Subway
Oscar
turkey
Meyer.
Meat.
He's
such a dog,
bro. Look like
what he
turkey meat.
You know
what I'm saying?
This
boy
look like
Frankenberry.
So yeah. I had a thing, so I'm looking up to them like me knowing like
you stupid.
I'm good, but I ain't that good. It's outnumbered. I'm looking at the number like, why ain't no? Well, Marquis Grissom ain't played in 20 years, man. You know what I'm saying?
There's some niggas out there though.
The one that the Braves they got, what his name? Michael Harris. What the one the Braves they got, Monte?
Michael
Harris. Yeah, Michael Harris. Yeah, like, but the percentage low, the percentage under 10. It's under 10% black in the MLB.
Oh, shit!
For real. What you laughing at, bro?
Oh, shit.
A nigga high, man.
So I'm talking about, like, slow and turkey.
Bro, pull up a picture of Sandy. He looked just like that. Ain't nobody, Monte, you seen the recent picture of Sam Sosa?
Oh, shit.
He bleached his skin,
bro.
What,
the perfect color? You seen some white turkey meat?
Boy, last time I saw a picture of that nigga, he had a cowboy hat on. He was dressed like Woody from Toy Story.
Pull up, <on, laughs> Sam. Hey, look, they in their phone. Hey, look, they in their phone.
They
goomin'. Hey.
Hey, man.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man. My jaw hurt, man. My jaw hurt, bro.
I told you, man, that name crazy, man.
Oh, man.
Oh, shit.
Hey, man, my jaw hurt, bro.
You see, so we turn to me.
Hey, Jay, you pull that picture up.
Yeah, pull that picture up.
You
where can it? Can't go.
Yeah. Sammy Sosa now.
Where Ryan at? Sammy Sosa now. Don't put Sammy Sosa then.
Yeah, don't put Sammy Sosa then. Put Sammy Sosa now. Hey, bro, you said. Hey.
Told you, nigga.
That nigga look like Shrek when he talk human.
Hey, fly. Little fly.
I told you, nigga.
Hey, DC love, DC love.
Look at him. Look at him.
Wait, turn it up,
look at him.
Press your button so I can turn light up.
Oh, shit.
Look at him. This segment of the show is dedicated to dark-skinned Sammy Sosa.
Look at this nigga. But it's not the same Sammy Sosa.
Right, nigga.
But that is hilarious, bro.
That nigga is Samuel.
Bro, I need somebody to tell. That nigga be darker than me, bro.
Yeah.
Dude,
yeah.
He was darker than me.
Yeah.
That man hit all the home runs.
I ain't gonna be able to eat Subway the same.
You stupid.
Well, y'all think it's stupid.
This ain't Mike, though.
No, hey, Sammy just did this shit because he needed some shit to do.
Right.
Ain't nobody told Sammy to do nothing.
He did. Hey, Mike did it slow.
Yeah, Sammy wanted to go viral. Sammy wanted to go viral, man.
That's funny.
Huh?
Sammy did it fast.
But salt and ice?
We don't know what the fuck he put on that shit.
Oh, who put that
on that shit? Hey, my man, that boy with salt
and ice. That shit you clean the swimming pool with.
Hey, dude.
But
I'm gonna put some salt and ice on your hand, watch this shit, too.
But this shit gonna burn.
Yeah.
We're gonna try to burn a hole in your skin,
man.
Nigga. Well, what?
Hey, Sammy, what the fuck you do? I don't know, I just do. What the fuck? What the fuck's wrong with you, man?
Subway turkey meat, bro.
Oh, boy. Something wrong with Sammy, man.
He tripped out,
man. Maybe all them steroids made him lose his mind. Maybe that shit started fucking with his skin because he did all them steroids.
What is shit the football player began?
Nah, man, sometimes they be hating themselves, dog.
Yeah, they be wanting to turn the whole
thing. They be hating their color. They be hating that shit. That's like a status
symbol. Tell them, like, do it, do it. You'll be better. They'll accept you. They'll do this and this. Money will make you do a whole lot of stupid shit.
You don't know what he had to go through, all that MLB racism and shit.
Nigga, well, why you do it when you left the league?
It don't matter.
It was fucking.
Nigga went through all the racism now, nigga.
But what?
It still happened.
You turned that motherfucker like.
I mean, you sat down. Let them folks do that to you. That's all I'm thinking about. You sat down and lay it down.
Nigga, people your whole body that. Like that.
People be doing that. They
he probably went
right.
Back a few times.
Can you make me more white,
man? Skin.
Can you make more white?
Yeah. How you want to look?
Like, I want more white.
Subway 30,
can you do me?
They gonna turn that into a cup.
He opened up a sandwich.
We can, get you like Subway turkey in the morning.
At some point, the doctor cut him off. God damn it, Sammy, there's nothing else I can do.
All your melanin's gone, man.
It's gone.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm talking about.
Nah, he ain't got that.
Bro,
he ain't
got to have that. All that life,
he ain't
bro.
Get hit in the head.
That
he played baseball.
Pink, man. That man, pink. Man.
Yeah, he fucked up.
There you be.
Man, pink. Man.
Something wrong with Sammy, man. He'll be all right, though. Fuck it. He going through something.
Yeah, boy. Whatever turned him that color.
Yeah, Subway turkey meat. Oh my God, Subway turkey meat.
You got him. Nah, I can't be around this nigga, man.
You saying that? You saying that, little?
Hey, I said that nigga ham sandwich pink.
I ain't gonna lie though, he shouldn't did that.
He
a legend. He a legend, bro. That like dude said Mike did it too though. But Mike shit didn't look like that though.
Bro, what if you was in school, bro, the nigga told the nigga that he like, but your skin is like
that's what I'm saying. Mike. You would thought Mike was white. I really thought Mike was white.
Boy, hey. Oh, this nigga crazy, man.
Hey, oh, shit.
Yo.
Ooh.